pleasant good evening to you baseball fans wherever you may reside. Roy Elia welcoming you to another night of Walla Walla Suites Baseball, coming to you tonight from Vince Genna Stadium in Bend, Oregon, where the Walla Walla Suites will take on the Bend Elks in the final game of a three-game series. The Elks winning the first two games of this series on Tuesday night by a score of 4-2, last night by a final count of 2-1. The Elks have clinched the series. The Suites out to salvage the final game of the three-game set here tonight. And as you probably figured out, we're going to be starting late once again. Mother Nature having her way earlier with rain and thunder and all those kinds of good things. Consequently, we are going to be starting here in just a few minutes as they continue to work on the field. This beautiful field here at a lovely facility, Vince Genna Stadium. Our pregame show this evening is presented by Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Walla Walla. An injury update presented by YMCA. No injuries to speak of as far as the Suites are concerned, and that is certainly good news. As far as keys to the game presented by Premier Mortgage. Now, the bottom line is, if the Suites are going to be successful tonight, they better score than more than one or two runs, because it certainly did not work well for them in the first two games of this series, losing on Tuesday night again by a score of 4-2 and losing last night by a score of 2-1. The pitching hasn't been all bad, but the offense needs to get things going here this evening if the Suites hope to salvage the final game of this three-game series. We'll have more from Bend, Oregon after we step aside for a commercial break on the Suites Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
With 7 retail locations across eastern Washington, Blue Line is the region's go-to Kubota dealer. But Kubota is far from all we provide. Blue Line represents more than 10 lines of agriculture equipment, including Gregoire and Land Pride. We carry parts and provide service for all major tractor brands, and our knowledgeable staff and certified mechanics will ensure your satisfaction. Blue Line is a proud partner of the Walla Walla Suites. Blue Line, building the future of agriculture.
Guess how much of this we're giving away this year? $2 million in cash and prizes. You're probably asking, where can I get some of that action? Legends Casino, that's where. Join the rewards club at legendscasino.com, because this is going to be a legendary year. Welcome to Legends Casino Hotel. Welcome to winning.
Hello fans, every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog. Nathan's Beef Hot Dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's Hot Dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They are juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's Hot Dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
Hey, we're back once again at Vince Genna Stadium in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia, now giving you the starting lineups for the upcoming game between the Walla Walla Suites and Bend Elks. The starting lineups are presented by Del Taco. First for the visiting Walla Walla Suites, as announced by manager Frank Mutes, leading off and playing center field will be Patrick Caulfield. Justin Foles, the third baseman, will bat second. Chaz Martinez will start in right field. He'll bat third. Cesar Lopez, the left fielder tonight, will bat in the four spot. Jordan Stubbings will bat fifth. He will be the designated hitter. Caleb Farmer will bat sixth and play shortstop. David Lavoida will play first base and bat seventh. Batting eighth, new kid on the block, catching tonight, Michael Petrie. And batting ninth will be the second baseman, Parker Price. Moving away from his usual shortstop position, he gets the start tonight at second base. And on the mound for the Walla Walla Suites will be right-hander Andrew Mosiello. The starting lineup now for the homestanding Bend Elks, as announced by manager Joe Dominic. Leading off and playing left field will be Vinny Savolta. Efrai Cervantes will bat second and play second base. Chase Fernland, the shortstop, will hit third. Batting fourth, the designated hitter, Dayton Provost. Batting fifth will be the third baseman, Zach Needham. Batting sixth, playing center field, Justin Parsons. Batting seventh and catching, Darren Johnson. Batting eighth and playing first base, Gabe Gonzalez. And the right fielder, Jake Jarvis, will bat ninth. And on the mound this evening for the Bend Elks is Kyle Wade. Those are the starting lineups for this evening's contest. We'll have more from Bend, Oregon after we step aside for another commercial break on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Life is more fun without ATM fees. So switch to Banner Bank Connected Checking. Use any ATM in the country, and we'll refund the fees. Spend what you earn on what you love with Connected Checking from Banner Bank. Switch today at bannerbank.com or at a Banner Bank branch near you. Unlimited surcharge rebates from non-Banner-owned ATMs in the U.S. Banner Bank, member FDIC.
The smell of fresh-cut barley. The sound of boots in a barn. The sight of the sun rising over the fields. Budweiser farmers don't just grow barley, they live it. That's because there's nothing simple about growing barley. It's early mornings every morning. It's a steady hand guiding a combine through the field. It's a loyalty to the land, and it's a respect for those who did it before you did. Barley is the soul of our lager. That's why we've been working with the same family-owned American farms for more than 50 years to harvest it. The secrets to growing this grain perfectly have been passed down through three generations. For them, it's a legacy. It's something to be proud of. And it's why only the best barley and locally sourced ingredients are used to make Budweiser. Budweiser is proudly raised across America. This Bud's from our barley farmers. This Bud's for you. Enjoy responsibly. Budweiser Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
And we're back once again at Vince Genna Stadium here in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia. A delay due to weather holding things up here this evening. We were scheduled to start at 6:35. We are past 7:05. Looks like we might be getting this contest underway at or around 7:15 this evening. The final game of the three-game series between the Walla Walla Sweets and the Bend Elks. Sweets coming into play tonight, one game up in the WCL South Division over three-time defending West Coast League champion Corvallis. Ridgefield is two games off the pace going into action this evening, and we will see the Raptors over the weekend in Ridgefield. Games tomorrow night and Saturday night scheduled for 6:35, and then on getaway day, a Sunday afternoon contest at 3:05. Now, I'm not sure if they're going to be chalking the baselines down the first and third baselines. They do have the batter's boxes all lined out and ready to go. And not exactly sure when we're going to get this game started here this evening. I'm thinking 7:15 or so. We started just over a half hour late last night because of weather. We were scheduled for a 6:35 start last night. We started at or around 7:07 last evening. This is game three of this three-game series, as we have noted. It's also game three of a six-game road trip for the Sweets. And after this road trip concludes, an off day on Monday, and then the Sweets will have a three-game series at home at Burleski Stadium on July 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. The Sweets will be playing host to the Cowlitz Black Bears. And during the course of that three-game series, there will be some promotions. For example, next Tuesday, Bud Light batting practice and $1 Del Taco Tacos. And then on July the 3rd, America the Great, presented by Wilbur Ellis. And on that particular evening, all fans entering the ballpark and making merchandise purchases will receive a 40% discount. Then on the 4th of July, it's being billed as America the Great Part Due. We certainly encourage fans to start off their 4th of July holiday the right way. There will be food and drink specials during the entire game on July the 4th. three different start times for those ball games. Next Tuesday's game is scheduled for 6:35. Next Wednesday, scheduled for 7:05. And then next Thursday's game will start at 10:35 in the morning. We'll be back to Bend, Oregon with more after we step aside for another commercial break on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Sweets Country, Sweets Baseball is here. Bring your coworkers, friends, church groups, and more to celebrate at historic Borleski Stadium. The best way to celebrate any event is at the Sweet Spot Party Deck, presented by Key Technology. Enjoy all-you-can-eat food and soft drinks from the gates open until the end of the third inning. Groups of 75 people or more receive special menu selection options, so be sure to make your reservation today. Call Dan at 509-522-BALL to reserve your night at the Sweet Spot, presented by Key Technology.
Les Schwab is proud to introduce two of our best tires ever, just in time for summer road trip season. There's our exclusive open range AT that we believe is our quietest, smoothest, and best all-season traction tire ever. Or the Reputation, our exclusive high-mileage premium passenger tire. Get even more road trip ready with our free pre-trip safety check. Stop by or book an appointment today at leschwab.com. Les Schwab Tires. Doing the right thing matters.
Every great Walla Walla adventure begins at visitwallawalla.com. Take in the wineries before a single cork is pulled. Explore the menus before you enjoy the restaurants. Catch a concert before it hits the stage. Discover the trails before you take them on. From a world of recreation and arts and culture to exciting events and outstanding accommodations, there's always more to discover, and it all starts at visitwallawalla.com.
And back once again at Vince Genna Stadium in Bend, Oregon, I'm Roy Elia. In just a few minutes, we will have the final game of this three-game series between the Walla Walla Sweets and the Bend Elks. The Sweets have scored just three runs in the first two games of this series. They are hoping for much better offense this evening. Let's hope the pitching can continue to hold up. The pitching in the first two games of this series have given up only six runs, just two last evening, but unfortunately for the Sweets, it proved to be enough for the Bend Elks to emerge victorious last night by a final score of 2-1. The Bend Elks being introduced as they take the field dressed in home light gold jerseys with navy blue numerals and navy blue lettering. They are sporting white pants this evening. The Walla Walla Sweets, dressed in road gray jerseys with navy blue lettering and navy blue numbers, and they will be donning a navy blue baseball cap here this evening. We'll have more from Bend, Oregon after we step aside for another commercial break on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Walla Walla's best little secret is out.
Everyone's talking about it.
CDJR of Walla Walla has become a volume dealer.
The Walla Walla Valley's biggest selection of inventory is on site now. Big city selection, and you get the small town prices. You don't want to miss out on the largest inventory of new and used vehicles in the valley. It's worth the drive.
Listen up, folks. Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Walla Walla is home of the nationwide warranty forever. Our references are your friends and neighbors. Call us or visit us online. I'm Joel Olson, and I approve this message.
Do you have real estate to sell? Consider United Country. United Country is the only national real estate system specializing in rural and small town real estate. In fact, over 600,000 people will browse our online listings this month at unitedcountry.com. One may be looking for property just like yours. Will yours be there?
No one knows the country like we do. United Country.
Find an office near you at unitedcountry.com.
Welcome to Hospitality. Welcome to Luxury. Welcome to Legends Casino Hotel. Visit legendscasino.com or call and book your stay today.
Stop.
And back once again in Bend, Oregon at Vince Gannon Stadium, I'm Roy Elia, now giving you the starting defensive alignment for the Bend Elks, presented by Blaze King. Zavolta in left field, Parsons in center, and Jarvis in right. In the infield, Needham at third, Fernland at shortstop, Cervantes at second, and Gonzalez at first. The starting battery for Bend, Wade pitching, and Johnson catching. We'll be back with the first pitch of tonight's ball game after we step aside for another commercial break on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Tasting fresh isn't hard with Blue Mountain Cider Company. As the official hard cider of the Walla Walla Sweets, our award-winning ciders have been crafted with love from local apples since 2003. Crisp, refreshing, and less filling than beer, Blue Mountain Cider is the perfect choice for any occasion. Check out our 8 flavors, including peach, cherry, and harvest blend this summer. These ciders are sure to be a home run. Join us on Facebook and at drinkcider.com to learn more. Blue Mountain Cider Company, an apple a day, one glass at a time.
Hello fans, every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog. Nathan's beef hot dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's Hot Dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They are juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's Hot Dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
And back again at Vince Genna Stadium here in Bend, Oregon, I'm Roy Elia. The first pitch by Wade to Patrick Caulfield is swung on and missed, and the count is 0-1. Our first inning this evening presented by the Paul Richardson Insurance Agency. Wade, right-handed pitcher, he is 1-1 pitch on the way. And Patrick takes it inside, ball one, one ball and one strike. Patrick coming into play tonight, number three in the West Coast League in hitting, with a .379 batting average. Pitch on the way, swung on and missed, and the count is 1-2. One ball and two strikes the count on Patrick Caulfield. Wade from the full wind, his 1-2 pitch on the way, and it's high, check swing, but he did not go around. Ball two, two balls and two strikes the count on Patrick Caulfield. And from the full wind is 2-2 pitch on the way. Wade, they call it a fair ball. He got it in front of home plate. The catcher, Johnson, pounces on it, throws to first in time. Patrick Caulfield going down the line that time with a bat in his hand. The home plate umpire ruling it was a fair ball, and manager Frank Mutes coming down the third baseline to argue his point with the home plate umpire, but fortunately it's going to go for naught. One up and one down here in the top half of the first inning, and that's how this contest gets underway. A little nubber in front of the dish, according to the home plate umpire. Caulfield running to first base with the bat in his hand. As it turned out, well, it was a fair ball, according to the umpire, and he got him at first base. And Justin Foles now swings at the first pitch, hits it right back to the mound to Wade, and Wade underhands to Gonzalez at first. So two quick outs here in the top half of the first inning. And that will bring up Chaz Martinez, the Sweets right fielder. Chaz hitting .273 on the season. He is 3-for-11. Wade's pitch is high and outside, one ball, no strikes. So Caulfield retired, a tough break for the Sweets. But Johnson alertly pounced on it and threw to first base to get the first out of the inning, and then a comebacker to Wade off the bat of Foles. The next delivery is fouled back and out of play by Chaz Martinez, and the count 1-1. We have just begun here in Bend after a 40-plus minute rain delay. Delighted to have you with us for our broadcast. I'm Roy Elia. Wade, the big right-hander, into the wide, and the pitch on the way to Chaz Martinez. He is low, ball two, 2-1, and the clouds going away such that the sun making its way into our eyes here in the press box. The 2-1 pitch on the way, and Chaz takes it low, ball three, 3-1. 3-1 on the UC Santa Barbara product. Left-handed hitter, the 3-1 pitch by Wade, and that's ripped into right field, but it's right at the right fielder Jarvis, who leaps into the air and makes the catch for out number three. After a half inning of play, Walla Walla no score, and the Bend Elks coming to bat on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dog.
Tasting fresh isn't hard with Blue Mountain Cider Company. As the official hard cider of the Walla Walla Sweets, our award-winning ciders have been crafted with love from local apples since 2003. Crisp, refreshing, and less filling than beer, Blue Mountain Cider is the perfect choice for any occasion. Check out our 8 flavors, including peach, cherry, and harvest blend this summer. These ciders are sure to be a home run. Join us on Facebook and at drinkcider.com to learn more. Blue Mountain Cider Company, an apple a day, one glass at a time.
Hello fans, every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog. Nathan's Beef Hot Dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's Hot Dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They are juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's Hot Dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
Make a splash this summer. Sign up for summer programs at the YMCA today. The Y has camps for kids and teens. There are day camps, sports, theater, and club camps. There are a lot of camps to choose from.
Parents, sign your kids up for a 3-month membership and save on all programming costs. You can sign up too and stay in shape this summer.
To register, visit www.ymca.org or call 509-525-8863.
Whatever your printing needs, Abbott.
Starting defensive alignment presented by Blaze King. Lopez in left, Caulfield in center, Martinez in right. Foles is at third, Farmer is at short, Price at second, Lavoida is at first, Andrew Mossiello is pitching, and Michael Petrie is behind the plate. And leading off the last half of the first inning for the Bend Elks is the left fielder, Vinny Savolta, who is hitting .231 on the season. And he's ready to face right-hander Andrew Mossiello. The Oregon product into the wind, and his pitch on the way. And it's low, ball one, 1-0. Sweets going quietly in the top half of the first inning. And now the Elks, their first opportunity offensively. Next delivery on the inside corner for strike one, and the count is 1-1 on Zavolta. Andrew Mossiello 0-1 on the season with an earned run average and an even 9. His 1-1 pitch on the way, and it swung on and missed. Actually foul tipped into the glove of catcher Michael Petrie, and the count now a ball and 2 on Vinny Savolta. Andrew Mossiello working quickly. He is into the wind. His 1-2 pitch on the way, and it's lined into center field for a base hit. Savolta leads off the Bend first inning with a single to center field on a 1-2 pitch, and that will bring up Efry Cervantes. Cervantes on the season hitting .241. Right-hander Andrew Mossiello will work from the stretch with a runner at first and nobody out. David Lavoida holding Zavolta on at first base. The stretch and his pitch on the way. And it's there for a strike, and the count is 0-1. Regardless of the outcome of tonight's game, the Sweets dropping a series for the first time this season. Been taking the first two games of this three-game set by scores of 4-2 and 2-1. And most of the Yellows pitch on the way. That misses outside, ball one, one ball and one strike. As we look at the outfield, they play Cervantes straightaway. Patrick Caulfield just a smidge into right center. Pitch on the way by Mosiello is there for a strike, and the count is 1-2. A ball and two strikes, the count on Cervantes. Middle of the infield in double play depth, the third baseman Justin Foles. Halfway, the stretch. Zavolta his lead, throw to first. Not in time. A ball and two strikes the count on Cervantes, a right-handed hitter. Mosiello goes to the stretch. Andrews pitch on the way, breaking ball. Just missed, and the count is 2-2. Thought the home plate umpire that time was taking a couple of steps back to make the called third call, but that call never came. Two balls and two strikes the count. And the stretch by Mosiello. And the pitch on the way, the 2-2, is swung on and missed for strike three. Since first base is occupied, Cervantes is through. He strikes out. And that will bring up Chase Ferdland, the Elks shortstop. He is hitting 302 this season. One on, one out here in the last half of the first inning. We are scoreless in Bend, Oregon. Tomorrow night, Saturday night, Sunday afternoon, we will be in Ridgefield for another series against a West Coast League South Division opponent. The stretch and the pitch on the way. It's low and outside, ball one. One ball and no strikes the count on Fernland. Zavolta at first with one out here in the bottom half of inning one. Mosiello shakes his head no, now says all right, he looks to first, goes to the stretch, and his pitch on the way. And it's there for a strike, and the count is 1-1. A ball and a strike on Chase Fernland. Sweets earlier today, a workout and a good one. According to skipper Frank Mutes, team appeared to be very, very focused indeed. Trying to ride the ship as the runner goes from first. The pitch swung on and missed. The throw down to second is not in time. The count is 1-2 on Ferdland, a stolen base for Zavolta. And now skipper Frank Mutes, thinking that the batter may have obstructed Michael Petrie. And some of the fans down below with some boos in light of this circumstance. So it is the second time that skipper Frank Mutes has spoken to the home plate umpire and unfortunately not getting the desired result. The count is 1-2. On Fernland. The Elks with a runner in scoring position with one out here in the bottom of the first inning. Zavolta, his lead from second base. Mosiello looks in for the sign. He goes to the stretch. He looks back to second and the pitch on the way. And it's low. Ball two, two balls and two strikes. You might recall earlier this year, at least one occasion, the Sweets stole a base, but then it was taken away because the umpires ruled obstruction. Mosiello has the sign from Petrie. And his 2-2 pitch On its way after two looks to second is low and outside, ball three, 3-2. Michael Petrie joined the ball club yesterday, a product out of the University of Washington. 3-2 is the count. Mosiello to the stretch momentarily. There it is. And the pitch on the way. And it's routed to the right side, taken by the second baseman, Parker Price. He throws him out, and on the play, Zavolta moves to third. Two down. Parker Price that time moving to his left to field that ground ball. And then throw to first baseman David Laboida in time for out number two. And that will bring up Dayton Provost, the designated hitter. He is hitting .231 on the season. The stretch by Mosiello. And the pitch, it's fouled back to the screen by the left-handed hitter. And the count is 0-1. We'll have a West Coast League update for you in a moment. Yakima Valley at Port Angeles, rained out. 0-1 pitch on the way, and that misses high. 1-1. In the top of the fourth inning in Corvallis, the Knights and Ridgefield are scoreless. Wenatchee with a 6-3 lead at Victoria in the bottom of the second. And in the bottom of the fourth, Kelowna and Portland in Kelowna, they are scoreless. 1-1 pitch on the way, and that misses. Ball two, 2-1. The Sweets nursing a one-game lead in the WCL South over Corvallis, hoping to stem the tide a bit with a win here tonight. Mosiello's 2-1 pitch, and that's swung on and missed. And the count is 2-2 on Provost. David Laboida hugging the first base line. Foles well off the line at third. The stretch, and the 2-2 pitch on the way by Mosiello is fouled back and out of play to the left. A 2-2 count on Dayton Provost. Middle of the infield is back. Back the shortstop Caleb Farmer on the first cut or two of outfield grass. The 2-2 pitch on the way, and it's a breaking ball that is just off the glove of Parker Price and into right field for a base hit. And Ben leads by a score of 1-0. So the Bend Elks score first. A two-out single by Dayton Provost. And Bend leads by a score of 1-0. A gallant attempt that time by Parker Price. Went as high as he could to try to snag that line drive off the bat of Provost. The ball going off his glove and then trickling into shallow right field. And that will bring up Zach Needham. Pitch on the way is fouled back to the screen. And it's 0-1 on the left-handed hitting Zach Needham, who is hitting .286. Coming into tonight's ball game. Needham had the game-winning RBI last night in the bottom half of the eighth inning. The stretch by Mosiello. And is 0-1 pitch on the way. That misses high. Ball one, 1-1. 1-0 Bend here in the last half of the first inning. Provost, his lead from first, held on by David Laboida. And the pitch on the way, and it's fouled. Bounces in between the dish and the pitcher's mound. And the count is now 1-2 on Needham. One in, one on, two out. Mosiello looks to first after getting the sign from Petrie. The stretch. His 1-2 pitch on the way, and it's lined into right field for a base hit. Going to second is Provost, and the Elks now with runners at first and second with two out. That will bring up the center fielder, Justin Parsons, who had a nice night last night. He singled and scored in the second inning, walked in the fourth. He singled in the seventh. He also flew out to center field to end the bottom of the eighth inning. Now two on with two out. The stretch by Mosiello. He looks back to second. He looks back a second time, and the pitch on the way, and it's foul back to the left and out of play, and the count is 0-1. Well, the Sweets last night broke that half a dozen or so game drought where the opponent scored first by scoring in the top half of the first inning, but tonight, the Bend Elks drawing first blood. The stretch. And Mosiello's pitch on the way. That misses high, ball one, 1-1. Bend with a run on three hits here in the last half of the first inning. That last delivery, 77 miles an hour from the Oregon Duck, Andrew Mosiello, the stretch. 1-1 pitch on the way, and it's bounced to the right side. Parker Price has it, and will throw him out. After one inning of play, Bend 1, Walla Walla no score, and we'll be back on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Hi, this is Doug with Columbia REA and Columbia iConnect. We are excited to partner again with the Walla Walla Sweets baseball team, so come on out and support the home team. Call us at 526-4041 for your internet needs with Columbia iConnect or your electrical needs for Columbia REA.
Holiday Inn & Express Walla Walla is proud to be the official hotel of the Walla Walla Suite. Our guests are sure to get a great night's sleep in one of our recently remodeled rooms, and our 24-hour pool and spa are perfect for round-the-clock relaxation. Each night at Holiday Inn Express Walla Walla is followed by a complimentary breakfast included with every stay. At Holiday Inn Express Walla Walla, you can catch some Z's while the Sweets catch some W's. Wins, that is.
It's now easier than ever to stay in touch on your smartphone, tablet, or computer with local community news, sports, and information from the Walla Walla Valley. Visit the Union Bulletin online and get the best in local sports and photography, plus trusted, need-to-know local community news and information. The UB is proud to support the Sweets and the Valley's communities and schools. Join the conversation at union-bulletin.com.
Our second inning this evening is presented by Grassy Refrigeration. Bend leading the Walla Walla Sweets by a score of 1-0. Cesar Lopez leads things off here in the top half of inning two. And Wade starts him with a breaking ball. It's swung on and missed, and the count is 0-1. Wade into the full line. His 0-1 pitch on the way, and that's swung on and missed, and the count is 0-2. No balls and two strikes the count on Cesar Lopez, getting the start tonight in left field for the Sweets. And the pitch on the way is lined back up the middle into center field, a base hit. Lopez jumping on that 0-2 delivery by Wade and lining it right back up the middle past Wade and into center field. And the Sweets have their first hit of the contest. And that will bring up the designated hitter, Jordan Stubbings, who's hitting 250 on the season, 9 hits in 36 at-bats, joined the ball club on the first road trip of the season to Wenatchee. Cesar Lopez on at first base, being held on by Gonzalez. The stretch by Wade, and the pitch on the way, breaking ball is there for a strike, and it's 0-1. Stubbings, and then shortstop, Caleb Farmer. The stretch. And Wade's pitch on the way. It's hit in the air to center field. And heading over into the right center field gap to make the catch is the center fielder Parsons, one out. Caleb Farmer hitting 216, a very versatile player. We have seen him at shortstop. We've seen him at third. We've seen him catch. In fact, he made a tremendous catch on a fouled bunt last night. One of the better defensive plays of the season. A lob toss to first base, and it went right into the ribs of Cesar Lopez. It's recovered by Gonzalez. He throws it back to his pitcher, Wade, who goes to the stretch. And his pitch on the way. And that's hit in the air to center field. Parsons coasting over to his left again to make another catch. And that's the second out of the inning. So Stubbings and Farmer both hitting balls reasonably well, but Parsons out there in center field making the grab, and on both occasions going to his left to do so. One on with two out here in the last half of the second. That will bring up first baseman David Laboida, who's hitting 207 on the season. The stretch by Wade. Lopez is lead from first. Pitch on the way, and it's there for a strike, 0-1. 1-0 Bend here in the top half of the second inning. The Elks looking to sweep. The Sweets looking to salvage here tonight. The stretch by Wade. And his pitch on the way. And David takes it low for a ball, and the count is 1-1. So we certainly enjoy the home cooking at the beginning of the season with 12 of the first 15 games at home. The Sweets now in the midst of a stretch where they're playing 12 out of 15 on the road. That stretch, of course, starting Tuesday night here in Bend. Pitch on the way to Laboida is low. Ball two balls and one strike. Sweets will be in Ridgefield this weekend and then host Cowlitz for a three-game series next Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and then it's back on the road again. Series at Kelowna and at Bellingham. The 2-1 pitch on the way. David takes it low, ball three. 3-1. Kyle Wade, right-handed pitcher, up on top of the pitcher's mound. Cesar Lopez, a short lead at first. The stretch. And the pitch on the way to Laboida. And he hits it off the leg of Wade. Wade picks it up and throws him out. A bad break there. Laboida got good wood on that one, but a kick save and a beauty by Wade. He then goes to the left of the mound, picks up the ball, and throws to first in time, and side retired. After an inning and a half, Bend 1, Walla Walla no score on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
With 7 retail locations across eastern Washington, Blue Line is the region's go-to Kubota dealer. But Kubota is far from all we provide. Blue Line represents more than 10 lines of agriculture equipment, including Gregoire and Land Pride. Carry parts and provide service for all major tractor brands, and our knowledgeable staff and certified mechanics will ensure your satisfaction. Blue Line is a proud partner of the Walla Walla Sweets. Blue Line, building the future of agriculture.
Guess how much of this we're giving away this year? $2 million in cash and prizes. You're probably asking, where can I get some of that action? Legends Casino, that's where. Join the rewards club at legendscasino.com, because this is going to be a legendary year. Welcome to Legends Casino Hotel. Welcome to winning.
Hello, fans. Every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great-tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog? Nathan's Beef Hot Dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's Hot Dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They are juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's Hot Dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
Back once again in Bend, I'm Roy Elia. After an inning and a half, the Bend Elks leading the Walla Walla Sweets by a score of 1-0. Elsewhere in the West Coast League, in the top of the fifth inning in Corvallis, the Knights and Ridgefield are scoreless. Top of the third in Victoria, the Harbor Cats trailing Wenatchee 7-3. Yakima at Port Angeles, rained out. And in the bottom of the fifth inning in Kelowna, the Falcons and Portland Pickles, no score. The first delivery to the leadoff hitter in the last half of the second. Catcher Darren Johnson is fouled back to the screen, and the count is 0-1. Andrew Mosiello's 0-1 pitch on the way. It's inside, ball one, one ball and one strike. Darren Johnson hitting 188 on the season. Mosiello from the full line. Andrews 1-1 pitch on the way. And that must have been inside, ball two, two balls and one strike. 2-1 on the left-handed hitting Darren Johnson. And Mosiello's pitch on the way. The 2-1 is there for a strike, and the count is 2-2. Ben with a run on three hits in the bottom of the first inning. The big hit of the inning, a two-out RBI single by Dayton Provost. And the 2-2 pitch on the way by Mosiello, swung on and missed for strike three. Petrie will throw to first baseman David Lapointe in time to complete the out, one down. Petrie taking that pitch in the dirt. And thus, having to throw down to first to complete the play. So a K for Andrew Mosiello, his second of the ball game. And the out completed 2-3. And that will bring up first baseman Gabe Gonzalez. And Mosiello's pitch on the way. It's low. Ball one, one ball, and no strikes. Gonzalez hitting at 261. Mosiello has the sign from Petrie. And the 1-0 pitch on the way. And it's low. Ball two. Two balls and no strikes. The Sweets began the season, of course, with an 8-0 homestand, including a couple of non-league wins over Highline, as the next delivery is bounced foul down the left side, and the count is now 2-1. The Sweets swept Corvallis, they swept Bend, and then took two from the Highline Bears. And the 2-1 pitch on the way, and it's there for a strike, and the count is 2-2 on Gonzalez. Sweet's first road trip, a series win in Wenatchee. Sweets took two out of three there. And the 2-2 pitch on the way, and it's outside, ball three, three balls and two strikes. On the last homestand, the Sweets went 4-2. They took two out of three from the Portland Pickles and 2-3 from Port Angeles. Andrew Mosiello has time called on him. Gonzalez steps out of the right-handed batter's box and now steps back in. And the payoff pitch on the way by Mosiello. Check swing, they say he went around, strike three. Petrie applies the tag, two down. And that will bring up Jake Jarvis, the Bend right fielder, who's hitting 191. He is out of Grand Canyon University, Phoenix, Arizona. Another beautiful part of this amazing country we call the United States of America. Pitch down low for ball one, one ball and no strikes. Jarvis, left-handed hitter. 1-0 pitch on the way by Mosiello, and it's foul tipped.
Whoa,
and to the right of home plate, and the count is 1-1. Yeah. Mosiello ready. Andrew into the wine. Is 1-1 pitch on its way, and it's low. Ball two, 2 balls and 1 strike. That 9 earned run average a bit misleading because Andrew had that just disastrous start against the Portland Pickles on the last homestand. Portland scored 6 in the top of the first. Ground ball hit to the right side, taken by the first baseman, Laboida. Laboida touches first, and side retired. And after 2 innings of play, Ben won. Walla Walla no score on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Life is more fun without ATM fees. So switch to Banner Bank Connected Checking. Use any ATM in the country, and we'll refund the fees. Spend what you earn on what you love with Connected Checking from Banner Bank. Switch today at bannerbank.com or at a Banner Bank branch near you. Unlimited surcharge rebates from non-Banner-owned ATMs in the U.S. Banner Bank, member FDIC.
The smell of fresh-cut barley. The sound of boots in a barn. The sight of the sun rising over the fields. Budweiser farmers don't just grow barley, they live it. That's because there's nothing simple about growing barley. It's early mornings every morning. It's a steady hand guiding a combine through the field. It's a loyalty to the land, and it's a respect for those who did it before you did. Barley is the soul of our lager. That's why we've been working with the same family-owned American farms for more than 50 years to harvest it. The secrets to growing this grain perfectly have been passed down through 3 generations. For them, it's a legacy. It's something to be proud of. And it's why only the best barley and locally sourced ingredients are used to make Budweiser. Budweiser is proudly raised across America. This Bud's from our barley farmers. This Bud's for you. Enjoy responsibly. Budweiser Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Michael Petrie up for the first time in 2019 for the Walla Walla Sweets, and the University of Washington Husky takes the first pitch from Wade for a ball. It's 1-0. And the next delivery on the way, the 1-0, is inside for ball two, 2 balls and no strikes. 1-0 bend here in the top half of the third inning of this West Coast League game. And Wade's pitch on the way. And that is low, ball three, 3 balls and no strikes. Michael Petrie to be followed by second baseman Parker Price. And back to the top of the order for Patrick Caulfield. And the 3-0 pitch on the way by Wade is a called strike, and the count is 3-1. The sun has just come back into play here as far as our view is concerned. And the pitch on the way is there for a strike. 3-1 pitch is there for a called second. And the count is now 3-2 on Michael Petrie.
I totally remember you. You were standing to my left.
Wade working from the full wide.
I was on your right.
And his pitch on the way. The payoff pitch is strike 3 called, 1-out. Petrie was ready to toss the bat away, but the official, the umpire, calling it a third strike, 1-out. And that will bring up Parker Price. And that will bring up Parker Price to face Wade. And his pitch on the way. That's low and inside, ball one, 1 ball and no strikes. Parker Price on the season hitting 159. And the pitch on the way, it's a strike. And the count is 1-1. 1 ball and 1 strike. Outfield plays Parker straight away. And the 1-1 pitch on its way. And that misses. Ball two, 2 balls and 1 strike. And the 2-1 pitch on the way. And Parker lifts it foul to the right side. And the count is now 2-2. A chilly night here in Bend, but the sun coming out now. A lot of clouds up above. Parker takes the next delivery low for ball three, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Another full count on a Sweets hitter. Wade into the wind, and his 3-2 pitch on the way, and it's outside, ball four. Nice at-bat for Parker Price. He draws a one-out walk from Kyle Wade. Parker at first with one out for center fielder Patrick Caulfield, who has retired 2-3 in the first inning on a ball that Caulfield and just about everybody else wasn't sure was fair, but the home plate umpire ruling, the little nubber in the home plate area, was a fair ball. Pitch on the way, and Caulfield hits it in the air, deep to left, and that ball is gone! Patrick Caulfield jumps on the first pitch from Wade and knocks it over the left field wall, and the Sweets take a 2-1 lead. A 401-foot blast by Patrick Caulfield, his team-leading third home run of the season. Patrick now has 11 RBIs in 2019. And now, another discussion. Frank Mutz coming down from the third base coach's box. And talking things over with the home plate umpire, who is now looking in the Bend dugout. Now, they're saying that Patrick might have done a little hot dogging as far as the bat is concerned. Flipped it in the air as he got a hold of that delivery from Wade. Oh, they were just asking, I guess, for the bat to be returned to the Sweets' third base dugout. All right. Now that that's been taken care of, that will bring up Justin Foles. And Wade's pitch on the way. That misses, ball one, one ball and no strikes. So Patrick Caulfield goes deep. And the Sweets lead by a score of 2-1. And the next delivery is out of the strike zone, ball two, two balls and no strikes. And the next pitch is there for a strike. And the count is 2-1. Now the clouds winning the battle between clouds and sun. The 2-1 pitch on the way. That's there for a strike, and the count is 2-2. Justin Foles. Hit one back to the mound his first time. And the next delivery is fouled off to the left, back and out of play. And the count is still 2 balls and 2 strikes on the Sweets' third baseman. And Wade, 2-2 pitch on the way, and that's swung on and missed for strike three. And that is Wade's second strikeout, both of them coming here in the third inning. And that will bring up Chaz Martinez. Chaz, his first time up, flew out to right field. And the first pitch on the way by Wade is out of the strike zone. Ball one, one ball and no strikes. That long fly by Patrick Caulfield, the Sweets' second hit in the ball game. Pitch on the way to Martinez. The 1-0 is there for a strike, and the count is 1-1. 2-1, the Sweets here in the top half of the third. And Wade's pitch is fouled back to the screen, and it's now 1-2 on Chaz Martinez. Chaz takes a practice cut and stands in and awaits the 1-2 pitch from Wade. And here it is. The 1-2 is low, ball two. 2 balls and 2 strikes. The ball blocked that time by the catcher, Johnson. And the count is even on Chaz Martinez. And the 2-2 pitch on the way by Wade. That misses high, ball three, 3 balls and 2 strikes. A full count on the Sweets' right fielder. And Wade's payoff pitch on the way is just outside for ball four. A walk to Chaz Martinez. And that'll bring up Cesar Lopez. Cesar singled to lead off the second inning, but got no further as Stubbings and Farmer both flew out to center field, and David Laboida grounded back to the mound. Laboida hit the ball hard, but the ball knocked down by Wade, and then he was able to get the out at first. Lopez lifts a fly ball into shallow center field, and the ball is grabbed out there and side retired. One of the infielders that time going out into shallow center to make the grab, I believe it was the second baseman Cervantes. We go to the last half of the third inning. The Sweets leading Ben by a score of 2-1 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Sweets Country, Sweets Baseball is here. Bring your coworkers, friends, church groups, and more to celebrate at historic Borleski Stadium. The best way to celebrate any event is at the Sweet Spot Party Deck, presented by Key Technology. Enjoy all-you-can-eat food and soft drinks from the gates open until the end of the third inning. Groups of 75 people or more receive special menu selection options, so be sure to make your reservation today. Call Dan at 509-522-BALL to reserve your night at the Sweet Spot, presented by Key Technology.
Les Schwab is proud to introduce two of our best tires ever, just in time for summer road trip season. There's our exclusive open range AT that we believe is our quietest, smoothest, and best all-season traction tire ever. Or the Reputation, our exclusive high-mileage premium passenger tire. Get even more road trip ready with our free pre-trip safety check. Stop by or book an appointment today at leschwab.com. Les Schwab Tires. Doing the right thing matters.
Every great Walla Walla adventure begins at visitwallawalla.com. Take in the wineries before a single cork is pulled. Explore the menus before you enjoy the restaurants. Catch a concert before it hits the stage. Discover the trails before you take them on. From a world of recreation and arts and culture to exciting events and outstanding accommodations, there's always more to discover, and it all starts at visitwallawalla.com.
We go to the bottom half of the third inning here in Bend. I'm Roy Elia, the Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 2-1. And Andrew Mosiello's first delivery of the last half of the third to Zavalta, the leadoff hitter for the Bend Elks, is low, one ball, no strikes. Next delivery on the way, and it's a strike on the outside corner. And the count is a ball and a strike. Sweets, their second lead of the series. They led 1-0 last night after an inning. Actually a half inning, an inning, and an inning and a half before Ben tied the ball game at the bottom half of the second inning. The next delivery is bounced foul to the left side, and the count is 1-2 on Vinny Zavalta. And the next delivery on the way by Mosiello. In on the hands and foul to the right of the Sweets' third base dugout. And it's still 1-2 on Zavalta. And from the full wide, Andrew Mosiello. He is 1-2 pitch on the way. And it's a breaking ball that's fouled by Zavalta. And it's still 1-2. The top of the order up here in the last half of the third inning. Zavalta to be followed by Efri Cervantes and Chase Fernland. And the 1-2 pitch on the way by Mosiello. Breaking ball is hit back up the middle. It's taken by the shortstop Farmer on the run. Throws to first just in time for the out. A nice job that time by Caleb Farmer charging the ball. And a strong throw to David Laboida for the first out of the last half of the third inning. And that'll bring up Cervantes, who struck out in the first inning. Top of the sixth in Corvallis, the Knights and Ridgefield, no score. Top of the fourth in Victoria, Wenatchee leading the Harbor Cats by a score of 8-3 as the first pitch is fouled back over the screen and out of play, 0-1. Yakima Valley at Port Angeles rained out in the bottom of the fifth inning in Kelowna. The Falcons and Portland Pickles, no score. And the 0-1 pitch on the way by Mosiello is there for a strike. And the count is 0-2 on Cervantes. He'll be followed by Chase Ferdinand. Will Cervantes. Mosiello has the sign from Petrie. And here's the 0-2 pitch on the way. And it's a breaking ball, low and outside. Ball one, 1-2. Cervantes with one RBI on the season. And from the full wind, the pitch on the way by Mosiello, and that's low and in the dirt, ball two. 2-2. The count is all squared on Cervantes. Parker Price, well to his left. 2-2 pitch on the way, and that's swung on and missed for strike three. A nice breaking ball that time. Low and away by Mosiello. Cervantes offers and comes up empty. Two up and two down here in the last half of the third for Chase Fernland. Parker Price not stationed where you would expect a second baseman to be stationed. Now he makes his way back to his right. And is where you might expect a second baseman to be defensively. And time is called for a moment. Now we're set. And Mosiello's pitch on the way to Ferdinand is a little high, ball one, 1-0. Chase Ferdinand this season with a home run and 8 RBIs. The 1-0 pitch on the way. And that misses, ball two, 2-0. Ferdinand grounded out to second base in the first inning. And here's the 2-0 pitch. No, time is called again. And now we are set and ready to go. And Mosiello's 2-0 pitch on the way. And that's low, ball three, 3-0. Andrew, thus far in the ball game, has given up 3 hits, all of them in the first inning. He retired the Elks 1-2-3 in the second. He was on the cusp of retiring them 1-2-3 here in the third, but that goes by the boards as he issues a 4-pitch walk to Ferdinand. Ferdinand took that delivery out of the strike zone, and that will bring up Dayton Provost, an RBI single in the first inning. 2-1 the sweeps, 1-1 with 2 out here in the last half of the third. Mosiello looks to first, goes to the stretch, and the pitch on the way, and it's fouled back to the left and out of play. Good cut that time by Provost, and the count is 0-1. Provost has 4 RBIs on the season, actually had 4 coming into the night. RBI number 5 coming in the bottom of the first. The stretch by Mosiello. And the pitch on the way, the runner goes, and the ball is lined into center field for a base hit. On his way to third is Ferdinand. The ball back into the infield, thrown in by Patrick Caulfield, and the Elks with a 2-out rally here. And runners are now at the corners with 2 out for Zach Needham. Provost is now 2-for-2 in the ball game. And that's 4 hits for the Bend Elks. And time called for a moment. Michael Petrie, an equipment repair, gets a new glove and now makes his way back behind home plate. Needham singled in the first inning. The last of three hits that Ben collected in the bottom of the first. The runners there leads Fernland from third and Provost from first. Osceola looks to first, goes to the stretch. His pitch on the way, and it's a called strike, 0-1. The Sweets hanging on to a 2-1 lead here in the last half of the third. The potential tying run is 90 feet away. The stretch. Osceola's pitch on the way, and it's swung on and missed, and the count is 0-2. Needham had a big cut at that one, but unable to make contact. No balls and two strikes, the count on Zach Needham. Mosiello looks in for the sign. He has it. He looks to first, goes to the stretch. And the 0-2 pitch on the way, and that's outside. Ball one, one ball and two strikes. 1-2 on Zach Needham. So far this season, he has four RBIs. A ball and two strikes, the count, the stretch, and a throw to first. A high throw, but handled by David Laboida. Provost back in time. 1-2 on Needham. The stretch by Mosiello. And the pitch on the way, it's swung on and missed. Tag applied, strike three, inning over. A big strikeout for Andrew Mosiello, and the Sweets continue to lead. We're now through three innings of play. Walla Walla 2, Bend 1 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Walla Walla's best little secret is out.
Everyone's talking about it.
CDJR of Walla Walla has become a volume dealer.
The Walla Walla Valley's biggest selection of inventory is on site now. Big city selection, and you get the small town prices. You don't want to miss out on the largest inventory of new and used vehicles in the valley. It's worth the drive.
Listen up, folks. Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Walla Walla is home of the nationwide warranty forever. Our references are your friends and neighbors. Call us or visit us online. I'm Joel Olson, and I approve this message.
Do you have real estate to sell? Consider United Country. United Country is the only national real estate system specializing in rural and small town real estate. In fact, over 600,000 people will browse our online listings this month at unitedcountry.com. One may be looking for property just like yours. Will yours be there?
No one knows the country like we do. United Country.
Find an office near you at unitedcountry.com.
Welcome to Hospitality. Welcome to Luxury. Welcome to Legends Casino Hotel. Visit legendscasino.com or call and book your stay today.
We go to the top half of the fourth inning here in Bend, Oregon. Along with tech guru and soft drink lover, Aaron Page, I'm Roy Elia. Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 2-1. And here in the top half of the fourth inning, the Sweets will send up designated hitter Jordan Stubbings, shortstop Caleb Farmer, and first baseman David Laboida. Our reset is presented by Columbia REA. Two runs, two hits, no errors for the Sweets. A run, four hits, and no errors for the Bend Elks. We'll have this day in history for you in just a moment. Pitch on the way to Stubbings. Is lifted in the air down the left field line, foul territory, and it will drop harmlessly to the turf. The count is 0-1. This day in history presented by Blue Mountain Cider Company. On this day in 1939, Brooklyn Dodgers tied the Boston Braves at 2-2. That game went a mere 23 innings. The 0-1 pitch on the way, and it's there for a strike. The count is 0-2. This day in 1956, the Indians trailed the Orioles 9-1. They came from behind to win 12-11 in 11 innings. And the 0-2 pitch on the way, and Stubbings fouls it back and out of play, and it's still 0-2. This day in 1980, former Dodgers pitcher Jerry Royce no-hit the San Francisco Giants by a count of 8-0. Pitch on the way, and Stubbings lifts it into center, coming up on the ball and making the catch in shallow center field is Parsons for out number one. Second time in the ball game that Stubbings has skied to center, and that will bring up Caleb Farmer. Kyle Wade in his fourth inning of work for the Bend Elks. Into the wind, his pitch on the way. And Farmer takes a strike. The count is 0-1. And Wade up on top. And his next delivery, the 0-1, is a called second strike. And the count is 0-2 on Caleb Farmer. He flew out to center field in the second inning. And the next pitch on the way by Wade is very high, ball one, 1-2. 1-2 on Caleb Farmer. Wade, into the wind, his pitch on the way. And that's low, ball two, 2-2. As we look further in the month of July, after this stretch of 12 out of 15 on the road, the Sweets will play three non-league games. Pitch on the way. The Farmer is hit to the left side, taken by the third baseman, Needham, and Needham throws him out, two down. And that'll bring up David Laboida, who hit back to the mound his first time. A hard hit by Laboida right back to the mound, a kick save and a beauty by Wade. He was then able to pick up the ball and get the out at first base. From the full wind, Wade's pitch. Out of the zone, ball one, 1-0. After this stretch of 12 out of 15 on the road, the Sweets will be playing a couple of games against the Military All-Stars at Burleski Stadium. The next pitch is out, ball two, 2-0. Those games will be played on July 11th and 12th, and then they will host the River City Athletics. Pitch a strike. They will play the River City Athletics on July 13th as part of a six-game homestand. Then an off day Sunday, and then a three-game series with Victoria. Laboida bounces to second base. Cervantes throws to first in time, and side retired after 3.5 innings of play. Walla Walla 2, Bend 1 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Walla Walla's best little secret is out.
Everyone's talking about it.
CDJR of Walla Walla has become a volume dealer.
The Walla Walla Valley's biggest selection of inventory is on site now. Big City Selection, and you get the small town prices. You don't want to miss out on the largest inventory of new and used vehicles in the valley. It's worth the drive.
Listen up, folks. Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram of Walla Walla is home of the nationwide warranty forever. Our references are your friends and neighbors. Call us or visit us online. I'm Joel Olson, and I approve this message.
Do you have real estate to sell? Consider United Country. United Country is the only national real estate system specializing in rural and small town real estate. In fact, over 600,000 people will browse our online listings this month at unitedcountry.com. One may be looking for property just like yours. Will yours be there?
No one knows the country like we do. United Country.
Find an office near you at unitedcountry.com.
Welcome to Hospitality. Welcome to Luxury.
Welcome to Legends Casino Hotel. Visit legendscasino.com or call and book your stay today.
Back once again in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia coming to you from Minskenna Stadium. Walla Walla Suites leading the Bend Elks by a score of 2-1. A new pitcher for the Suites, Wyatt Boone, now into the ballgame, a right-hander. He will face Jason Parsons, or I should say Justin Parsons, here in the last half of the fourth. Still thinking about Walla Walla American Legion Baseball, making a Jason Parsons reference. Boone working from the stretch, and his pitch on the way to Parsons is hit to the right side. On the ground, Parker Price has it and throws him out. One down, a three bouncer to second baseman Parker Price, and he retires Parsons with a throw to first baseman David Lavoida, covering the bag at first. And that will bring up Darren Johnson, the Elks catcher tonight. He struck out in the second inning. The stretch by Boone. And the pitch on the way. And Johnson sprays it to the left side, foul. And the count is 0-1. The stretch by Boone. And it's 0-1 pitch on the way. And that misses ball one, one ball and one strike. Again, very difficult to see. The sun right in our faces. Very difficult to see the outfield. The stretch by Boone. And the pitch on the way by the Saddleback product. That misses ball two. Two balls and one strike. A 2-1 count on Darren Johnson. Stretch by Boone. And his pitch. It is hit in the air to center field. And under the ball and making the grab is Patrick Caulfield in straightaway center for out number two. And that will bring up Gabe Gonzalez, the Elks first baseman. Gonzalez struck out in the second inning. Wyatt Boone to the stretch. And the right-hander's pitch on the way. It's there for a strike, and the count is 0-1. Wyatt Boone, his pitch. The 0-1 is hit up the middle, a diving stop by Farmer, throw to first. Gets Lavoida off the bag, but what a play. What an effort that time by Caleb Farmer, going to his left, diving for that ball. Gets up, throws to first, high. And Gonzalez credited with an infield single. And that will bring up Jake Jarvis, the Bend right fielder. Heck of an effort, though, by Caleb Farmer. Boone will work from the stretch. He looks to first, goes to the stretch, and the pitch on the way. And it's there for a strike. The count is 0-1. No balls and one strike the count on Jake Jarvis. Jarvis was retired 3 unassisted to end the last half of the second inning. Boone looks to first, the stretch, and the delivery by Wyatt Boone. And it's outside, ball one, one ball and one strike. 5 hits in the ball game now for the Bend Elks. The Sweets with 2 hits in the game. One of them a 2-run home run in the third inning by Patrick Caulfield. The pitch, and Gonzalez slaps it to the left side. It is taken by the third baseman of the Sweets, Justin Foles, and the toss across in time. And side retired. And after 4 innings of play, Walla Walla 2, Bend 1 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Tasting fresh isn't hard with Blue Mountain Cider Company. As the official hard cider of the Walla Walla Sweets, our award-winning ciders have been crafted with love from local apples since 2003. Crisp, refreshing, and less filling than beer, Blue Mountain Cider is the perfect choice for any occasion. Check out our 8 flavors, including peach, cherry, and harvest blend this summer. These ciders are sure to be a home run. Join us on Facebook and at drinkcider.com to learn more. Blue Mountain Cider Company, an apple a day, one glass at a time.
Hello, fans. Every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great-tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog. Nathan's beef hot dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's hot dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They are juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's hot dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
Make a splash this summer. Sign up for summer programs at the YMCA today. The Y has camps for kids and teens. There are day camps, sports, theater, and club camps. There are a lot of camps to choose from.
Parents, sign your kids up for a 3-month membership and save on all programming costs. You can sign up too and stay in shape this summer.
To register, visit www.ymca.org or call 509-525-8863.
Yeah, we go to the top half of the fifth inning here in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia, blinded by the light, so to speak, the sunlight, that is. Michael Petrie leads off the top of the fifth for the Sweets and fouls a pitch to the left side on the ground, and the count is 0-1. In the bottom of the fourth inning, Wenatchee with an 8-5 lead at Victoria. Corvallis, a 2-0 lead over Ridgefield in the top of the eighth inning. Pitch on the way, and that's inside, 1-1. In the bottom of the fifth, in Kelowna, the Falcons and Portland Pickles scoreless. Yakima Valley at Port Angeles rained out. Next delivery is swung on and missed, and the count is 1-2. One non-league game this evening, the Cowlitz Black Bears playing host to the Highline Bears. No score on that game as of yet. 1-2 on Petrie. And the 1-2 on the way to Michael is hitting the air to right field, going back a handful of strides and making a one-handed catch is the right fielder Jarvis for out number one. Michael struck out looking in the third inning. He's retired here on the top of the fifth on a fly ball to right. And that will bring up Parker Price, who walked in the third and scored on Patrick Caulfield's two-run home run to left. And the pitch on the way. Wade finds the mark with a breaking ball. A called strike. The count is 0-1. 2-1 the Sweets here in the top half of the fifth inning. And the pitch. And low, ball one, 1-1. Wade not wasting any time. Into the wind. And his 1-1 pitch. And that's low, ball two, 2-1. Well, the clouds may be prevailing over the sun here in mere moments. Pitch on the way, the 2-1 is hit hard and through the right side and into right field for a base hit. Parker Price with a good, hard shot through the right side of the Bend infield. And the Sweets now have 3 hits in the game, and that will bring up Patrick Caulfield, who launched a 401-foot home run to left field his last time up. Patrick retired 2-3 his first time up, leading off the ball game. Wade goes to the stretch. And the pitch on the way to Patrick is high. Ball one, 1-0. Parker Price being held on by Gonzalez at first base. A short lead for Parker over there. Wade looks to first, goes to the stretch. And his pitch on the way. A bunt to the third base side. And throwing out Parker Price at first base is Wade. A nice bunt laid down by Patrick Caulfield, and that advances Parker Price to second base. That'll bring up Justin Foles. Nice job that time by Wade to get the out. Pounced on that bunt by Patrick Caulfield. It's to the right of the mound. And a strong throw to Gonzalez to record the out. But on the play, Price advances to second. Justin Foles is 0 for 2 in the ball game. The stretch by Wade. A look back to second and the pitch. And Foles takes a strike, 0-1. Foles struck out his last time up in the third inning. The Sweets leading 2-1 here in the top of the fifth. The stretch by Wade. And the pitch on the way, and Foles fouls it back to the backstop. He fouled it, and the ball off the glove of the catcher Johnson, and back to the backstop, and the count is 0-2. Parker Price is leadoff second with two out here in the top half of the fifth inning. The stretch by Wade. He looks to second. His 0-2 pitch on the way, and it's very high. Nice job that time by the catcher Darren Johnson to get out of his catcher's stance. Climb the ladder to get that delivery. And it's 1-2. Wade looks in for the sign from Johnson, and now he steps off the rubber. Now back on. The stretch by Wade. And the 1-2 on its way after a look to second base is hit right back to him on a hop. He will run to first. He'll underhand to Gonzalez and side retired. After 4.5 innings of play, Walla Walla 2, Bend 1 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Whatever your printing needs, Abbott's Printing does it all. Signs and banners, rich, full-colored, high-quality commercial and digital printing, direct mailings, full-color business cards, and postcards. If you want a printing job done right, then Abbott's Printing is the place to be. Abbott's Printing provides award-winning quality and outstanding customer service. Visit Abbott'sPrinting.com to view their selection or call 453-8202. That's 453-8202. Abbott's Printing, where the excellence is on paper.
Del Taco proudly supports the Walla Walla Sweets. Visit Del Taco on Meadowbrook Boulevard near Walmart and enjoy fresh food at a fair price. Try our tacos, burritos, and some of our best-kept secrets, burgers, shakes, and crinkle-cut fries. At Del Taco, we cook our pinto beans from scratch, freshly grate cheddar cheese, hand-chop whole tomatoes, and slice avocados to bring you a meal that is unfreshing believable. Del Taco.
At Banner Bank, we know how much it means to feel at home, and our home loan experts are dedicated to helping you achieve your dreams. So whether you're refinancing, making some home improvements, or buying a new place, you can count on us to help you find the right loan. Visit one of Banner Bank's many locations throughout the West, or find us at bannerbank.com. Banner Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
We go to the bottom half of the fifth inning here at Vince Gannett Stadium in Bend. I'm Roy Elia. Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 2-1. Boy, weather continuing to play havoc. We have just been informed that the Kelowna-Portland game up in Kelowna has been stopped because of rain. Earlier, Yakima Valley at Port Angeles called because of the wet stuff. Wyatt Boone's first delivery to Zavalta, leading off the bottom half of the fifth inning, is out of the strike zone for a ball, and it's 1-0. The stretch by Wyatt, and his pitch on the way. And that's popped up into shallow right field. Coming up is Chaz Martinez. Chaz Udrich makes the two-handed catch for out number one. And that will bring up Efri Cervantes, who is 0 for 2 in the ball game. He has struck out twice. Both times swinging. Both times against Andrew Mosiello, who struck out 5 in his 3 innings of work. One out, nobody on here in the bottom of the fifth. And Wyatt Boone's pitch is a little low and inside, ball one. 1-0 the count. the stretch. And the pitch on the way by Boone is there for a strike, and it's 1-1. When the Sweets play host to the Military All-Stars on July 11th and 12th, $2 of every ticket sold at the gate. As Boone misses with the 1-1 pitch, it's now 2-1. $2 of every ticket sold at the gate will be donated to a local nonprofit that assists veterans and military personnel in the Walla Walla community. So please keep that in mind and purchase your tickets for upcoming Sweets home games. The next delivery by Boone is a strike, and it's now 2-2 on Cervantes. The stretch and the 2-2 pitch on the way, and that's low. Ball three, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Wyatt Boone in his second inning of work. Gave up a hit in the fourth inning, but that's all. The stretch and the pitch on the way, the payoff pitch. Where in the world was that pitch? Ball four. Must have been low. And that'll bring up Chase Ferdinand. He's 0 for 1 officially. He grounded a second in the first inning. He walked in the third. The Sweets leading 2-1. One on, one out here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. And it appears the clouds have prevailed over the sun once and for all. Or so we think. And the pitch on the way by Boone is there for a strike, and it's 0-1. Those two games noted a moment ago against the Military All-Stars. Part of a 6-game homestand that the Sweets will have in mid-July. The stretch and the pitch by Boone. He misses high, ball one, 1 ball and 1 strike. Cervantes, his lead from first, being held on by David Laboida.
You got this!
Boone looks to first, goes to the stretch, and his 1-1 pitch on the way, and it's low. Ball two, 2 balls and 1 strike. Two and one is the count on Fernland. Boone looks to first, goes to the stretch. And Wyatt's 2-1 pitch on the way. And that's hit hard into left center field. Gonna get down for extra bases. Caulfield up with the ball. He gets it in the Farmer. The run will come into score, and we're tied at two. So the And that will bring up Dayton Provost, who is 2 for 2. So a hard shot into the left center gap. Yeah, that 3-2 pitch isn't looking big now, is it? We are tied at 2 here in the last half of the fifth inning. Fernland with a double into the left center alley to bring home Cervantes. The stretch by Wyatt Boone and the pitch to Provost. And that's outside, ball one, 1 ball and 0 strikes. Bend with 1 run in the first inning, the Sweets with 2 in the 3rd. Bend with a run here in the bottom of the 5th. And a runner on at 2nd. Pitch on the way by Boone. Breaking ball is fouled back and out of play, and the count is 1-1. Provost, a left-handed hitter. And Wyatt Boone goes to the stretch. He looks back to 2nd. And there's 1-1 pitch on the way. That's bounced to the right side and into the Elks first base dugout. It's now a ball and two strikes on Provost. 1-2 is the count on the left-handed hitter. The stretch by Boone, he looks back to second. 1-2 pitch on the way. It's fouled off to the left side, back and out of play, and it's still 1-2. We have a 2-2 tie here in the last half of the fifth inning. One and two on Provost, the Elks' designated hitter, the stretch. And Wyatt Boone's pitch, Rudder thought about going, now hustles back to second as the pitch misses for ball two. Two balls and two strikes is the count. Wyatt Boone gets the sign from Michael Petrie, his battery mate. It is 2-2 pitch on the way. Breaking ball is hit down the first baseline, and it's called foul. Just foul. It was fielded very nicely over there by David Laboida. But they rule a foul ball, and it's still 2-2 on Provost. We noted that Andrew Mosiello had a nice outing of three innings. He struck out five and issued just one walk in those three innings. The stretch by Boone. The 2-2 pitch on the way, and that's high, ball three, three balls and two strikes. Provost making Boone work here in the last half of the fifth inning. A 2-2 tie, bend with the potential go-ahead run at second base in the person of Fernland. And the payoff pitch by Wyatt Boone, breaking ball, grounded to the right side, foul, and it's still 3-2. Loyal fans in full force here tonight. Had nearly 2,100 on Tuesday night for a $2 Tuesday. About 570 or so here last night. Payoff pitch on the way by Boone, and that's very high, ball four. And that'll bring up Zach Needham, who struck out his last time up in the third inning. Elks now at first and second, with only one out here in the bottom of the fifth. We are tied at two. Zach Needham steps in. Wyatt Boone to the stretch. Looks back to second, and the pitch on the way, and it's hit in the air, just a little dunker into right field for a base hit. Martinez up with the ball. The runners will move up 90 feet as Needham just hit a little dunker that just barely got on the outfield grass and just out of the reach of Parker Price. And now the Sweets in big trouble. The Elks with the bases loaded with only one out for Justin Parsons. Not a bad pitch that time by Boone. But Needham able to muscle it just past Parker Price on a soft line. And it just did find its way onto the right field grass. So Boone got the first out here in the fifth inning, and then a 3-2 walk to Cervantes, who could have easily been called out. The pitch was very, very close, but it wasn't meant to be. First pitch is fouled back to the screen, and the count is 0-1. Parsons retired 4-3 on two occasions so far tonight. Fernland is at third, Provost at second, and Needham is at first. The stretch by Boone. And his pitch on the way, the 0-1, is there for a strike, and it's 0-2. Just over the inside corner was that delivery to Parsons. The runners there leads. Boone to the stretch. His 0-2 pitch on the way. And it's swung on and missed. Strike three. Two down. And that will bring up Darren Johnson, who is 0-2. He struck out in the second. And he flew out to center field in the fourth inning. Darren Johnson, a left-handed hitter against the right-hander Wyatt Boone. Boone to the stretch. And the pitch on the way to Johnson. It's popped up, back and out of play, and the count is 0-1. Wyatt Boone looks in for the sign from Michael Petrie. He has it. It is 0-1 pitch on the way. It's popped up, back and out of play, and it's now 0-2 on Darren Johnson. Johnson struck out in the second and flew out to center in the fourth, as we noted a moment ago. Wyatt Boone to the stretch. His 0-2 pitch on the way. Breaking ball. Grounded foul down the right side. It's still 0-2. We are tied at 2. The Elks with the bases loaded and 2 out here in the last half of the 5th inning. Fans below making some noise. Trying to encourage Johnson during this at-bat. Wyatt Boone to the stretch. And his 0-2 pitch on the way. It's fouled back to the screen. Darren Johnson with a good cut that time. Fouls it back. It's still 0-2. We started 40-plus minutes late this evening because of inclement weather. We started about 7:17 this evening. Wyatt Boone to the stretch. And the pitch on the way, the 0-2 is a breaking ball, and that's laced foul to the right side. Past the first base coach. And it's still 0-2. A 2-2 tie here in Bend, Oregon. And timeout is called. Skipper Frank Mutes going to make his way out to the mound to have a chat with Wyatt Boone and catcher Michael Petrie. In the meantime, let's see if we can get you another West Coast League update during this break in the action. Oh, they're going wild up in Victoria. They're in the bottom of the 5th inning. The Harbor Cats leading Wenatchee 10-8. In the bottom of the 8th in Corvallis, the Knights with a 2-0 lead over Ridgefield. Portland at Kelowna rained out, stopped in the bottom of the 5th inning. Yakima Valley at Port Angeles called because of rain. Pitch on the way, swung on and missed by Johnson for strike three, and that will end the inning. Back-to-back strikeouts with the bases loaded for Wyatt Boone. Some clutch pitching there to keep it a 2-2 tie after 5 innings of play on the Sweets Radio Network presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Hi, this is Doug with Columbia REA and Columbia iConnect. We are excited to partner again with the Walla Walla Sweets baseball team, so come on out and support the home team. Call us at 526-4041 for your internet needs with Columbia iConnect or your electrical needs for Columbia REA.
Holiday Inn & Express Walla Walla is proud to be the official hotel of the Walla Walla Suite. Our guests are sure to get a great night's sleep in one of our recently remodeled rooms, and our 24-hour pool and spa are perfect for round-the-clock relaxation. Each night at Holiday Inn Express Walla Walla is followed by a complimentary breakfast included with every stay. At Holiday Inn Express Walla Walla, you can catch some Z's while the sweets catch some W's. Wins, that is.
It's now easier than ever to stay in touch on your smartphone, tablet, or computer with local community news, sports, and information from the Walla Walla Valley. Visit the Union Bulletin online and get the best in local sports and photography, plus trusted, need-to-know local community news and information. The UB is proud to support the Sweets and the Valley's communities and schools. Join the conversation at union-bulletin.com.
We go to the top half of the sixth inning here in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia. The Walla Walla Sweets and Bend Elks tied at two. Wyatt Boone able to get himself out of some big, big trouble in the bottom of the fifth inning. The Elks had a run in, had the bases loaded with one out, but Boone recording back-to-back strikeouts. He fanned Justin Parsons and then fanned Darren Johnson for the final out of the inning. New pitcher for the Bend Elks is Andrew Clark, and his first delivery to Chaz Martinez, leading off the top half of the sixth inning, very high for ball one. One ball and no strikes. Chaz is 0 for 1 in the ball game officially. And the 1-0 pitch on the way. And the breaking ball is there for a strike, and the count is 1 and 1. Clark, a right-handed pitcher, goes to the stretch. And his 1-1 pitch on the way. And that misses outside. Ball two. Two balls and one strike. The scoreboard says 1-2, but I believe that is incorrect. And the pitch on the way. Martinez dribbles it down the third baseline. It is a foul ball. And the count is now 2-2. Martinez flew out to right field in the first inning, and he walked in the third. Chaz Martinez, left-handed hitter, starting in right field. He has also played left field during the course of the season. He's also been the Sweet's designated hitter on occasion out of UC Santa Barbara. Clark goes to the stretch. And the pitch on the way is hit high and deep to right center field. Way, way back, and this one is gone! Chaz Martinez, a 411-foot home run to right center field. And the Sweets lead by a score of 3-2. And some hooting and hollering going on in the Sweets dugout. And rightfully so. 411 feet for Chaz Martinez. And a lead for the Sweets here in the top of the sixth. First delivery to Cesar Lopez, a ball, and it's 1-0. And the next pitch on the way by Clark. Cesar bounces it to the right side. It's bobbled by Gonzalez. Can he recover? No, he cannot recover. He tried to backhand it. And then after a little bobble and a rumble, bumble, stumble, fumble, and so forth, Cesar Lopez is aboard. We'll wait and see how they score it. They're going to score it an error on Gonzalez. That hard bouncer by Cesar Lopez. And that will bring up Jordan Stubbings, who has flown out to center field twice in the second and in the fourth. The Sweets with two home runs in this ball game. And Clark's pitch on the way to Stubbings. Breaking ball misses high. One ball, no strikes. The ebb and flows of this game. The stretch. And the 1-0 pitch on the way to Stubbings. And it's hit into right center field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Stubbings loops one into the right center area. That is three consecutive sweets aboard. And Stubbings advances Cesar Lopez to second base. And now a conference between Fernland and the pitcher Clark. And that has concluded. Now Caleb Farmer steps into bat. Caleb is 0 for 2. The stretch. Pitch on the way, and it's outside, ball one. One ball and no strikes. The corner's in defensively for Bend, middle of the infield in double play depth. The stretch. The 1-0 pitch on the way after a couple of looks to second base. Is hit in the air, left center field, a base hit! That's in the left center gap. That will score one. Stubbings to third. Farmer to second with an RBI double, and the Sweets lead 4-2. Cesar Lopez scores on the play. And that'll bring up David Laboida. Runners at second and third, nobody out. The stretch. And Clark's pitch on the way, and it's there for a strike, and the count is 0-1. A nice delivery there. Nice breaking ball. The count is 0-1. Stubbings at third, Farber at second. The Colorado Mesa products. Clark's pitch on the way. Laboida pops it up. Shallow left field. Coming up on the ball is Zavolta. He makes the catch. Stubbings a couple of steps down third baseway, but goes back as the throw comes in from the outfield. One down. David Laboida now 0 for 3 in the contest, and that will bring up Michael Petrie, who struck out looking in the third inning. He flew out to right field in the fifth. Sweets still at second and third, now with one out. Two runs in. Chaz Martinez, a leadoff home run here in the top of the sixth inning to right center field. Cesar Lopez reaching on an error by Gonzalez. A single by Jordan Stubbings. An RBI double by Caleb Farmer. Now a flyout by David Laboida to shallow left. Corners in for Bend. And the pitch on the way to Petrie is lined into left field, a base hit. That will score one, and Farmer will hold at third. Michael Petrie, welcome to the Walla Walla Sweets. An RBI single lined into left, and the Sweets lead 5-2. Here comes manager Joe Dominick out of the Bend dugout, and that will be all for Andrew Clark. A pitching change here in Bend. The Sweets leading by a score of 5-2. And we'll be back on the Sweets Radio Network presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
With 7 retail locations across eastern Washington, Blue Line is the region's go-to Kubota dealer. But Kubota is far from all we provide. Blue Line represents more than 10 lines of agriculture equipment, including Gregoire and Land Pride. We carry parts and provide service for all major tractor brands, and our knowledgeable staff and certified mechanics will ensure your satisfaction. Blue Line is a proud partner of the Walla Walla Sweets. Blue Line, building the future of agriculture.
Guess how much of this we're giving away this year? $2 million in cash and prizes. You're probably asking, where can I get some of that action? Legends Casino, that's where. Join the Rewards Club at legendscasino.com, because this is going to be a legendary year. Welcome to Legends Casino Hotel. Welcome to winning.
Hello fans, every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog Nathan's Beef hot dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's hot dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They're juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's hot dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
Back once again in Bend, Oregon, the new pitcher for the Bend Elks is Joe Williams. He replaces Andrew Clark, a product out of Iowa Western Community College. He faced six batters here in the sixth inning. At the moment, he's given up three runs. And the Sweets have runners at the corners with one out for Parker Price. Joe Williams out of Pomona Pitzer, and he takes over here in the top half of the sixth inning. Three runs in for the Sweets, who lead by a score of 5-2. Williams has concluded his warm-up tosses and will now face Parker Price. Parker is 1-for-1. He walked and scored in the third on Patrick Caulfield's two-run home run, and he singled with one out in the fifth. Williams has the sign. No, he does not. He steps off the rubber. And now timeout going to be called. Darren Johnson, the catcher, going to go out and talk to Williams. Runners at the corners. Caleb Farmer is at third. Michael Petrie is at first. One out here in the top of the sixth. 5-2 the Sweets. Williams taking a lot of time out there. Looks to first, goes to the stretch. And his pitch on the way. It's there for a strike, 0-1. No balls and one strike to count on Parker Price. The runners there leads from first and third. The stretch by Williams. And his pitch on the way. Parker takes another strike, and it's 0-2. No balls, two strikes on Parker Price. Middle of the infield in double play depth. The stretch. And the 0-2 pitch on the way, and it's bounced to the left side, foul. A foul ball, and it's still 0-2. And a good thing the third baseman Needham that time fielding it and then throwing home and throwing wildly past the catcher Johnson. But perhaps it was the byproduct of the ball being called foul. If it had been fair, well, might have been a different story. 0-2 on Parker Price. Williams looks to first, goes to the stretch. His 0-2 pitch on its way, and it's inside, ball one. Nice job that time by Darren Johnson to secure that pitch out of the strike zone. And it's 1-2 on Parker Price. Now the stretch. Here is the 1-2 pitch on the way to Parker. And he misses, ball two, two balls and two strikes. 2-2 on Parker Price, starting this evening at second base. Williams looks to first, goes to the stretch. And here's the 2-2 pitch on the way, and it's outside, ball three. Three balls and two strikes. Let's see if they might send Petrie from first. I doubt it. 3-2. Here's the payoff pitch. on the way. He is going, and Parker Price lines the ball into right field, a base hit. On his way to third is Petrie. Farmer crosses the plate, and the Sweets lead 6-2. Oh, be a son of a gun. They did send Michael Petrie, and he advances all the way to third on that hit by Parker Price. Four runs in for the Sweets here in the top of the sixth. And stepping up to the plate, Patrick Caulfield. Tech guru Aaron Page informing me that Corvallis did in fact defeat Ridgefield by a score of 2-0, so the Sweets need to win here tonight to maintain a one-game lead in the WCL South standings. The pitch to Caulfield, and he fouls it back. Parker Price was moving on the pitch, and the count is 0-1. Heck of an at-bat by Parker Price a moment ago, down 0-2. Worked it to a full count and then dropped a nice single into right. An RBI single. Pitch on the way to Caulfield. It's outside. Ball one. One ball and one strike. Patrick, his last time up, he sacrificed 1-3 in the fifth inning. 6-2 the Sweets. A look to first by Williams. The stretch. And the 1-1 pitch to Caulfield. And it's fouled back. And the count is 1-2. A ball and two strikes on the Sweets center fielder, soon to be a UCLA Bruin. One and two. Williams shakes his head no. Long hesitation, now looks to first, goes to the stretch. And the pitch on its way, and it's inside. Throw through to second base, a double steal attempted, and the throw home, not in time. Are they going to call obstruction? Yes, they are. Two down. So a huge break for Bend as they rule that Caulfield obstructed. Price stole second. Petrie comes home, but they call Patrick Caulfield for obstruction, I believe. And another bad break for the Sweets. Well, Caulfield is still up. Well, I thought they were calling obstruction on the play, but maybe they're just saying that the runners go back. And Caulfield is still in there. Two balls, two strikes. All right. Joe Williams, the Bend pitcher, looks to first, goes to the stretch. And his pitch on the way, the 2-2, is lifted in the air to right field. That should get the run home. Back on the ball is Jarvis. He makes the catch, tagging at third. And coming across the plate from third is Michael Petrie, sacrifice fly Patrick Caulfield, and the Sweets now lead by a score of 7-2. And Justin Foles will be the ninth Sweet to bat here in the sixth inning. The Sweets leading 7-2. Joe Williams to the stretch. And the pitch on the way. It's outside. One ball, no strikes. Patrick Caulfield now with a dozen RBIs on the season. Three in this game. A two-run homer in the third. And now a sacrifice fly to right. One ball, no strikes on Justin Foles. The stretch. And the pitch on the way. Foles takes that one outside. Ball two. Two balls and no strikes. Chaz Martinez started the fun here in the top of the sixth inning with a 411-foot home run to right center field. The Sweets leading 7-2. The stretch. And the 2-0 pitch on the way to Foles. And it's on the outside corner for a strike, 2-1. Two balls and one strike on Justin Foles. The league leader, I should say, in doubles coming into tonight with 9. And the 2-1 pitch on the way by Williams. And Foles takes it low, a delayed steal, and Parker Price slides into second base safely, and the shortstop up to get the throw that time tumbles over the top of Parker. Fernland did a nice job that time to prevent the ball from going into center field. He and Parker exchange pleasantries at the second base bag, and Parker steals second and is now in scoring position with 2 out. 3 balls and 1 strike on Justin Foles. Joe Williams to the stretch. He looks back to second. Twice. 3-1 pitch. And it's outside, ball 4. And that will bring up Chaz Martinez for the second time in this innings. The Sweets have batted around here in the top half of inning number 6. Chaz greeted reliever Andrew Clark with that leadoff home run to right center. Sweets now at first and second with 2 out. And Williams looks back to second twice. The pitch on the way. And it's there for a strike, 0-1. Price at second. Foles at first. The stretch by Williams. And the pitch on the way to Chaz. And he bounces it to the left of the mound. It's taken by Williams. He underhands to first in time and side retired, but a very good inning for the Sweets, who lead after 5.5 innings of play. Walla Walla 7, Ben 2 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Life is more fun without ATM fees. So switch to Banner Bank Connected Checking. Use any ATM in the country and we'll refund the fees. Spend what you earn on what you love with Connected Checking from Banner Bank. Switch today at bannerbank.com or at a Banner Bank branch near you. Unlimited surcharge rebates from non-Banner owned ATMs in the U.S. Banner Bank, member FDIC.
The smell of fresh cut barley. The sound of boots in a barn. The sight of the sun rising over the fields. Budweiser farmers don't just grow barley, they live it. That's because there's nothing simple about growing barley. It's early mornings every morning. It's a steady hand guiding a combine through the field. It's a loyalty to the land, and it's a respect for those who did it before you did. Barley is the soul of our lager. That's why we've been working with the same family-owned American farms for more than 50 years to harvest it. The secrets to growing this grain perfectly have been passed down through 3 generations. For them, it's a legacy. It's something to be proud of. And it's why only the best barley and locally sourced ingredients are used to make Budweiser. Budweiser is proudly raised across America. This Bud's from our barley farmers. This Bud's for you. Enjoy responsibly. Budweiser Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
We go to the bottom half of the 6th inning here in Bend, Oregon at beautiful Vince Gannon Stadium. I'm Roy Elia. The Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 7-2. A new pitcher for the Sweets, Dimmick Wood, now into the ball game in place of Wyatt Boone, who threw 2 innings here this evening. And Dimmick Wood will face the 8, 9, and 1 hitters in the Bend order. Gabe Gonzalez, the first baseman, then Jake Jarvis, the right fielder, and then back to the top of the order for left fielder Vinny Zavolta. Gonzalez is 1-for-2. He struck out in the second inning. In the fourth inning, a 2-out single. Dimmick Wood will work from the stretch. to start the bottom of the sixth. And his pitch on the way. And Gonzalez hits it high and deep to left field. And that ball is off the wall. A long single for Gonzalez. No, they're calling it a home run. I thought that Chaz Martinez got the ball in, but apparently the ball did clear the left field fence, and Frank Mutes wanting an explanation. Well, they're going to call it a home run, and Dimmick Wood greeted very rudely by Gonzalez, who goes after the first pitch and hits the ball evidently over the left field wall, and we now, just like that, have a 7-3 ball game in favor of the Swedes. So Frank Mutes disputing that. But it's a home run, and that'll bring up Jarvis. And Dimmick Wood's pitch is low, one ball, no strikes. So Chaz Martinez led off the top of the sixth with a home run to right center. Gonzalez leads off the bottom of the sixth with a home run to left. The stretch by Dimmick Wood. And his pitch on the way. And it's hit hard on a bounce and pass Parker Price into right field. Two hard hits to start the bottom of the sixth inning by the number 8 and 9 hitters in the Bend order. And now we're back to the top of the order for Zavolta. So Clark was treated rudely in the top of the sixth by the Sweets. And Dimmick Wood treated in a rather respectful fashion here in the bottom of the sixth, giving up a leadoff home run to Gonzalez. And now a hard single that nearly undressed Parker Price at second base. That ball was scalded. That'll ring up Zavolta, who is 1-for-3 in the ball game, the stretch by Wood. And the pitch on the way. It's there for a strike, and the count is 0-1. The Sweets leading at 7-3 here in the bottom of the sixth inning, but we still have a long way to go in this one. Dimmick Wood has the sign from Michael Petrie. The stretch. And his pitch on the way. The 0-1 is low and outside. A good stop by Petrie. Negotiating to his right. The count is a ball and a strike on Zavolta, who has scored one of the three Bend runs in this ball game. And a throw to first base, and back in time is Jarvis, who just recorded Bend's 9th hit in this ball game. And time called. Now we're set. Dimmick Wood to the stretch. And his 1-1 pitch on its way. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. And it's 1-2. Gonzalez, a leadoff home run here in the bottom of the sixth, and then a single to right by Jarvis. Now a 1-ball, 2-strike count on Vinny Zavolta. Dimmick Wood to the stretch. And the pitch on the way. Breaking ball is popped up into right field. Chaz Martinez over to his left. He makes the catch for out number one. And that will bring up Efri Cervantes, the second baseman, who walked and scored in the fifth. Prior to that, he struck out twice in the first inning and again in the third. Cervantes steps up. Dimmick Wood to the stretch. And the pitch on the way to Cervantes. Is there for a strike, 0-1. The Sweets leading 7-3 here in the bottom of the sixth inning. One on, one out, one in for the Bend Elks. Wood looks to first, goes to the stretch. And his pitch on the way, the 0-1 is there for a strike, and it's 0-2 on Cervantes. One of my favorite names, one of my favorite first names, Efry. Spelled E-F-R-Y. Dimmick Wood will throw to first. And Jarvis is back. Owen 2 on Cervantes, the stretch. And the 0-2 pitch on the way. Runner goes. Pitch is swung on and missed. The throw down to second is not in time. And are they going to call obstruction? Yes, they are. And I believe that will bring the bottom of the sixth inning to a conclusion, and it will. So a swinging strikeout for Cervantes. Forget about the stolen base, as Jarvis is called out because of obstruction or interference on the part of the batter Cervantes. So one run for the Elks here in the bottom of the sixth, and that is all. And after six innings of play, Walla Walla 7, Bend 3 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Sweets Country, Sweets Baseball is here. Bring your coworkers, friends, church groups, and more to celebrate at historic Borleski Stadium. The best way to celebrate any event is at the Sweet Spot Party Deck, presented by Key Technology. Enjoy all you can eat food and soft drinks from the gates open until the end of the third inning. Groups of 75 people or more receive special menu selection options, so be sure to make your reservation today. Call Dan at 509-522-BALL to reserve your night at the Sweet Spot, presented by Key Technology.
Les Schwab is proud to introduce two of our best tires ever, just in time for summer road trip season. There's our exclusive open range AT that we believe is our quietest, smoothest, and best all-season traction tire ever. Or the Reputation, our exclusive high-mileage premium passenger tire. Get even more road trip ready with our free pre-trip safety check. Stop by or book an appointment today at leschwab.com. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing matters.
Every great Walla Walla adventure begins at visitwallawalla.com. Take in the wineries before a single cork is pulled. Explore the menus before you enjoy the restaurants. Catch a concert before it hits the stage. Discover the trails before you take them on. From a world of recreation and arts and culture to exciting events and outstanding accommodations, there's always more to discover, and it all starts at visitwallawalla.com.
We go to the top half of the seventh inning here in Bend. I'm Roy Elia. Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 7-3. Our reset presented by Blue Mountain Cider Company. Seven runs, seven hits, no errors for the Sweets. Three runs, nine hits, and one error for the Bend Elks. Our seventh inning this evening is presented by Tyotin Dental. The talented team at Tyotin Dental has been taking care of the family dental needs of Sweets Country since the inaugural season. And the family-owned practice has been taking care of families in the valley for nearly three generations. Your dental wellness and beautiful smile are their priority. Look good, feel good with Tyotin Dental. A new pitcher on the mound for the Bend Elks. It is left-hander Brendan Turcotte. He takes over here in the top half of the seventh inning. And the first hitter he'll face will be Sweets left fielder Cesar Lopez. Turcotte into the wind, and his pitch on the way to Cesar is bounced to the right side. It is taken by Cervantes, his throw to first in time for out number one. And that will bring up Jordan Stubbings, the designated hitter, who singled and scored during that five-run sixth inning. Tell me, wasn't that a fun inning? That was a lot of fun. Jordan Stubbings, right-handed hitter, to face the left-hander Turcotte. And the first pitch on the way is high, ball one, one ball and no strikes. One and oh on the sweets, designated hitter. Turk on into the wind, and his pitch, the 1-0, is down low, ball two, two balls and no strikes. Turcotte has the sign from Johnson, and his pitch, and that's high, ball three, three balls and no strikes. Checking the West Coast League scoreboard in the bottom of the seventh, Victoria with a lead at home over Wenatchee, 12-8. A final, Corvallis defeating Richfield, 2-0. Next delivery to Stubbings is low and in the dirt for ball four. A four-pitch walk to Jordan Stubbings with one out here in the top of the seventh inning. And that will bring up his Colorado Mesa teammate during the spring, Caleb Farmer. Farmer doubled into left center field for an RBI in the sixth inning. Portland Pickles, Kelowna Falcons, halted by rain in the bottom of the fifth inning. Yakima Valley at Port Angeles called because of rain. And the pitch to Caleb Farmer, a called strike, and it's 0-1. Turcotte, the fourth bend pitcher of the night, looks to first, his pitch. And it's inside to Caleb Farmer. Ball one, one ball and one strike. 1-1 on Caleb Farmer. Jordan Stubbings, his lead from first, held on by Gonzalez. 1-1 pitch. That's high and outside, ball two. Good velocity, but out of the strike zone. Two balls and one strike. Again, the Sweets needing a victory here to maintain a one-game lead in the WCL South Division. Wenatchee, we noted earlier, trailing Victoria, and Corvallis shutting out Richfield by a score of 2-0. As Farmer takes the next pitch out of the zone, ball three, three balls and one strike. I wouldn't sell that Wenatchee team short. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if they try to stage a comeback. The Sweets certainly got a belly full of that when they met the Apple Sox in Wenatchee earlier this year. 3-1 pitch on the way, and it's a called strike. Looked a little high, but they call it a strike. And it's 3-2. Three balls, two strikes on Caleb Farmer. Third baseman Needham playing at halfway. The stretch. And the pitch on the way, and it's grounded to the right side. It is flipped to second for first. Throw to first. They call it double play. 4-6-3 on the double play. Cervantes flips it to Fernland to get Stubbings, and then the throw back to first in time to get Caleb Farmer. A 4-6-3 double play. Side retired, and after 6.5 innings of play, Walla Walla 7, Ben 3 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Sweets Country, Sweets Baseball is here. Bring your coworkers, friends, church groups, and more to celebrate at historic Borleski Stadium. The best way to celebrate any event is at the Sweet Spot Party Deck, presented by Key Technology. Enjoy all-you-can-eat food and soft drinks from the gates open until the end of the third inning. Groups of 75 people or more receive special menu selection options, so be sure to make your reservation today. Call Dan at 509-522-BALL to reserve your night at the Sweet Spot, presented by Key Technology.
Les Schwab is proud to introduce two of our best tires ever just in time for summer road trip season. There's our exclusive open range AT that we believe is our quietest, smoothest, and best all-season traction tire ever. Or the Reputation, our exclusive high mileage premium passenger tire. Get even more road trip ready with our free pre-trip safety check. Stop by or book an appointment today at leschwab.com. Les Schwab Tires, doing the right thing matters.
Every great Walla Walla adventure begins at visitwallawalla.com. Take in the wineries before a single cork is pulled. Explore the menus before you enjoy the restaurants. Catch a concert before it hits the stage. Discover the trails before you take them on.
From a world of recreation and arts and culture to exciting events and outstanding accommodations, there's always more to discover. And it all starts at visitwallawalla.com.
We go to the bottom half of the seventh inning here in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia, the Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 7-3. And Dimmick Wood here in the last half of the seventh will face the number 3, 4, and 5 hitters in the Bend order, beginning with shortstop Chase Berglund. Right-handed hitter against the right-handed pitcher. Dimmick Wood, the stretch. And his delivery on the way to Fernland is there for a strike, and the count is 0-1. On Fernland, who is 1-for-2 in the game. He doubled his last time up in the fifth inning. That double was good for an RBI. Next delivery is popped up right side. Is it playable? David Laboida to have a look, and it's just out of play, and the count is 0-2 on Fernland. No balls and two strikes on Chase Fernland. Dimmick Wood, the stretch, and his 0-2 pitch forthcoming to Fernland, and it's low and outside on a bounce, and the count is 1-2. Dimmick Wood to the stretch. And is 1-2 on the way to Fernland. Breaking ball, a check swing, an excuse me swing. And it trickles to the right foul, and it's still 1-2. The Sweets trying to salvage the final game of this three-game series. At the moment leading 7-3, we have just begun the last half of the seventh inning. The stretch. And Wood's 1-2 pitch. It's outside and low. Ball two. Two balls and two strikes. Fernland, he'll be followed by designated hitter Dayton Provost and then third baseman Zach Needham. Dimmick Wood nods all right. Goes to the stretch. And his 2-2 pitch on the way. It's swung on and missed. Actually, foul tipped into the glove of catcher Michael Petrie for strike three. One out. That is 9 strikeouts for Sweets pitching in this ball game. The starter, Andrew Mosiello, struck out 5 in 3 innings. Wyatt Boone, 2 strikeouts, both coming in the fifth. Dimmick Wood ended the sixth with a strikeout, now starts the bottom of the seventh with a K. Dayton Provost, 2-for-2. He's also reached base on a walk, and the first pitch to him is high. Ball one, 1-1, 0-2. That pitch, 78 miles per hour. Provost, left-handed hitter. Wood goes to the stretch. And his 1-0 pitch on the way, and it's popped up foul. Back and out of play down the left side, and the count is now 1-1 on Dayton Provost. He singled for an RBI in the first. He singled in the third. He drew a walk in the fifth. Did Provost. The stretch by Dimmick Wood. The 1-1 pitch on its way. and it's fouled back to the left again over the screen, and the count is now 1-2. The bed manager, Joe Dominick, a gentleman in every sense of the word, enjoyed speaking with him when the team was in Walla Walla earlier this month, some 2.5 weeks ago. The stretch. And the 1-2 pitch on the way to Provost. Did he go around? A check swing, or did he foul tip it at the plate? The ball in and out of the glove of catcher Michael Petrie. Provost just did get a piece of it, and it's still 1-2. They're blessed here in Bend to have a gentleman such as Joe Dominick as their manager. And we are blessed, of course, in Walla Walla to have the likes of Frank Mutes and Larry Price. Big hole up the middle for Provost. Over toward the right field line is Parker Price. Next delivery is in the dirt into the backstop, and it's now 2-2. Two balls and two strikes on Provost. Parker Price stationed where he is because it is a left-handed hitter. Up to bat. And another left-handed hitter to follow, Zach Needham. The stretch. And the 2-2 pitch on the way is fouled back and out of play. Still 2-2. The Sweets leading 7-3. One out, nobody on here in the bottom half of the seventh inning on a chilly night here in Bend. We started this contest some 40 minutes late because of inclement weather. We started last night about a half hour late because of that very reason. The stretch. And Woods 2-2 pitch on the way. It's outside, ball three, 3-2. Heck of an at-bat here for Dayton Provost as he looks to get on here in the last half of the seventh. 3-2 is the count. The stretch by Wood. And his payoff pitch. On the way, and it's foul, or actually hit down the left field line in foul territory. And it's back and out of play, and it's still 3-2. Cesar Lopez in left field, Patrick Caulfield in center, Chaz Martinez in right, Justin Foles at third, Caleb Farmer at short, Parker Price at second, and David Laboida is at first. The battery at the moment, Dimmick Wood pitching, Michael Petrie catching. And the payoff pitch on the way, and it's a breaking ball. Strike three called, two down. Two down. And if we were at Burleski Stadium, it would be happy time for the fans. Because that is the 10th strikeout for Sweets pitching in the ballgame. That'll bring up Zach Needham. Needham so far tonight is 2-for-3. Couple of singles in the first and in the fifth. Sandwich in between a strikeout in the third. The stretch by Dimmick Wood. And the pitch on the way to Needham. And it's a little high, ball one. One ball and no strikes. The Sweets leading 7-3 here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Thanks in part to a 5-run sixth inning. A solid start for the Elks' Kyle Wade, who went the first 5 innings. Pitch on the way. And where in the world was that pitch? Ball two, 2-0. Maybe a little inside, I don't know. A little something, that is for sure. Dimmick Wood, the sign from Michael Petrie, the stretch. And the 2-0 pitch on the way, and that's high ball three, 3-0. 3-0 on Needham. David Laboida, tight on that first base and right field line. Foles off the line at third. And the 3-0 pitch, it's there for a strike, and it's 3-1. Three balls and a strike on Zach Needham. Chilly, chilly night. See a star or two off in the distance. 3-1 pitch on the way. And that ball is hit high and deep to right field, but back on the ball is Chaz Martinez. Might have hit it off the end of the bat. Chaz makes the catch in deep right field and side retired. Needham had a good swing, but he might have hit that one off the end of the bat. But we'll take it. We'll take the out. We'll take three up, three down anytime, won't we? After seven innings of play, Walla Walla 7, Ben 3 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Tasting fresh isn't hard with Blue Mountain Cider Company. As the official hard cider of the Walla Walla Sweets, our award-winning ciders have been crafted with love from local apples since 2003. Crisp, refreshing, and less filling than beer, Blue Mountain Cider is the perfect choice for any occasion. Check out our 8 flavors, including peach, cherry, and harvest blend this summer. These ciders are sure to be a home run. Join us on Facebook and at drinkcider.com to learn more. Blue Mountain Cider Company, an apple a day, one glass at a time.
Hello fans, every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog. Nathan's beef hot dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's hot dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They are juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's hot dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
Make a splash this summer. Sign up for summer programs at the YMCA today. The Y has camps for kids and teens. There are day camps, sports, theater, and club camps. There are a lot of camps to choose from.
Parents, sign your kids up for a 3-month membership and save on all programming costs. You can sign up too and stay in shape this summer.
To register, visit www.ymca.org or call 509-525-8863.
To the top of the eighth inning here in Bend, I'm Roy Elia. Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 7-3. David Lavoida to lead things off here in the top half of the eighth inning against Turcotte. Left-handed pitcher, Brendan's first pitch on the way to Lavoida is very high, ball one, one ball and no strikes. The Sweets leading by a score of 7-3. A 1-0 count on David Lavoida. And the pitch on the way by Turcotte is on the outside corner for strike one. A ball and a strike on David Lavoida. He's 0-for-3 in the ball game. Hit back to the mound in the second. Grounded out to second in the fourth. He flew out to left field in the sixth inning. The next delivery misses. And the count is 2-1 on David Lavoida. Turcotte taking his time, and now Lavoida calls time. We could call up those West Coast League standings for a moment. We'll get those to you. That would be greatly appreciated. Thank you, Tech Guru. Next delivery misses. Ball three, three balls and one strike. Bellingham Bills leading the West Coast League's North Division with a 12-6 record, actually in a virtual tie for first with Victoria. And the pitch on the way to Lavoida is out of the strike zone. Ball four, a leadoff walk here in the top of the eighth for David Lavoida. Port Angeles Lefties are in third place with a 9-11 record. Wenatchee Apple Sox 4.5 off the pace at the moment, 7-10. Yakima Valley Pippins 8-12. They are 5 back. The Kelowna Falcons are 6-11, 5.5 games off the pace. And now a pinch runner at first base for the Sweets, for David Lavoida. It looks like Ben Ferris is in to run. Ben Ferris will run for David Lavoida. And the batter for the Sweets is Michael Petrie. The stretch by Turcotte. And the pitch on the way. on the outside corner for strike one, 0-1. Michael, his last time up, single to left field for an RBI as part of that five-run sixth inning. His first hit as a sweep. Turcotte, the stretch. And the pitch on the way. It's taken inside, 1-1. At the moment, the Sweets with a half-game lead over red-hot Corvallis. The Knights have won 6 in a row and 12 of their last 15 games. Sweets 12-5, Knights 12-6. Ridgefield, 2.5 off the pace at the moment, 10-8. Next delivery is swung on and missed, and the count is 1-2. Bend Elks at the present time 8-9, 4 games back of the Sweets. The Portland Pickles are 8-12. They are 5.5 games back, and the Cowlitz Black Bears were in non-league action this evening. They are 5-13. They are 7.5 games out of first. The stretch by Turcotte. And the pitch on the way to Petrie. It's outside. Ball two, 2 balls and 2 strikes. We will be in Ridgefield tomorrow to open a 3-game weekend series with the Raptors. The stretch. And the pitch on the way by Turcotte. Strike three called on the outside corner, 1 out. And that will bring up Parker Price. Parker Price. He walked and scored in the third on Patrick Caulfield's 2-run homer. He singled in the fifth and singled for an RBI in the sixth. And Turcotte's pitch. It's low ball one, 1-0. 1-0 on number one. The stretch. And Turcotte. It's 1-0 pitch. And that's outside ball two, 2-0. 1-1 here in the top half of the eighth inning. The Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 7-3. Ben Ferris pinch running for David Lavoida, his lead from first, being held on by Gonzalez. The 2-0 pitch is fouled back to the right and out of play, and it's 2-1 on Parker Price. I'm thinking that Brock Efon will go in defensively for the Sweets in the bottom of the eighth inning, but that merely a hypothesis on my part. The stretch. And the pitch on the way by Turcotte. It's fouled back to the screen, and the count is 2-2. Parker had a good rip. And fouled it back ever so emphatically back to the screen, and it's 2-2 on Parker Price. Turcotte has the sign from Johnson, the stretch. He looks to first. And the pitch on the way. And Parker bounces it back up the middle. Going to lead the second baseman to the first base bag. Throw to second for one. And a throw back to first, not in time. 4-6 fielder's choice, Cervantes to Ferdlin to get the out on Ben Ferris. And safe at first base on the fielder's choice is Parker Price. And back to the top of the order for center fielder Patrick Caulfield. That 2-run home run in the third that gave a Sweets a 2-1 lead. Ben tied it in the fifth, but the Sweets scoring 5 times in the top of the sixth. And Parker Price on his way to second, the pitch low for a ball. And Parker will slide into second with a stolen base. A 1-0, no strike count on Patrick Caulfield. In the sixth inning, Patrick with a sacrifice fly to right field for his third RBI of the ball game. The stretch, Turcotte looks back to second. As he goes to that stretch, now he will step off. And now step back on. To the stretch, his pitch, low and outside. Ball two, two balls and no strikes on Patrick Caulfield. This ball game 2.5 hours old, and we're in the top of the eighth inning. Again, we started about 42 minutes late because of weather. The stretch and the pitch. It's inside, ball three, three balls and no strikes. 3-0 on Patrick Caulfield. The corner's playing at halfway. Middle of the infield is back. Outfield plays him straight away. 3-0 pitch, and it's there for a strike, 3-1. Nice pitch that time by Turcotte. Three balls, one strike on Patrick Caulfield. Now the stretch by Turcotte. He looks back to second. And the pitch on the way. And it's lined down the right field line. Fair! That will be another RBI for Caulfield. He is on his way to second with an RBI double coming in to score Parker Price. And the Sweets lead 8-3. And that will bring up Justin Foles. The Sweets back up by 5, 8-3. That a boy, Patrick. That a baby. Some very productive at-bats in this game. Sweets laying the lumber to the Bend bullpen. Pitch on the way to Justin Foles is there for a strike, and it's 0-1. Again, a nice outing for Kyle Wade of the Bend Elks. He went the first five. The stretch. And the pitch to Foles. That's lifted back and out of play. Foul. Hits the top of the press box. If people in here weren't awake before, they are now. And the count is 0-2 on Justin Foles. The stretch by Turcotte. And the pitch on the way to Foles is outside. Ball one, one ball and two strikes. The Sweets leading 8-3 here in the top of the eighth inning. Stretch by Turcotte. His pitch on the way, and Foles rips it down the left side and just by skipper Frank Mutes. Got a little pelvic thrust in on there as he watched that shot off the bat of Foles. Whistle on by. It's 1-2. And the pitch on the way by Turcotte, and Foles lifts the ball in the air to right field. Coming up on the ball is Jarvis. Does he have it? Yes, he does. A nice catch that time by Jarvis, and side retired. And after 7.5 innings of play, Walla Walla 8, Bend 3 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Whatever your printing needs, Abbott's Printing does it all. Signs and banners, rich, full-colored, high-quality commercial and digital printing, direct mailings, full-color business cards, and postcards. If you want a printing job done right, then Abbott's Printing is the place to be. Abbott's Printing provides award-winning quality and outstanding customer service. Visit abbottsprinting.com to view their selection or call 453-8202. That's 453-8202. Abbott's Printing, where the excellence is on paper.
Del Taco proudly supports the Walla Walla Sweets. Visit Del Taco on Meadowbrook Boulevard near Walmart and enjoy fresh food at a fair price. Try our tacos, burritos, and some of our best-kept secrets, burgers, shakes, and crinkle cup fries. At Del Taco, we cook our pinto beans from scratch, freshly grated cheddar cheese, hand-chop whole tomatoes, and slice avocados to bring you a meal that is unfreshing believable. Del Taco.
At Banner Bank, we know how much it means to feel at home, and our home loan experts are dedicated to helping you achieve your dreams. So whether you're refinancing, making some home improvements, or buying a new place, you can count on us to help you find the right loan. Visit one of Banner Bank's many locations throughout the West or find us at BannerBank.com. Banner Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Brady Heeroy now into the ball game to pitch for the Walla Walla Sweets as we go to the bottom half of the eighth inning. The Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 8-3. Brady Heeroy in this inning will face the 6, 7, and 8 hitters in the Bend lineup. Also for the Sweets defensively, Ben Ferris is now in right field. Chaz Martinez is now at first. He moves to first base from right field where he started the contest. Was stationed out there for the first 7 innings of this ball game. A final warm-up toss for Brady Heeroy. The throw through to second base by catcher Michael Petrie. And we are just about set here for the bottom half of the eighth inning. Justin Parsons to lead things off. He is 0 for 3 tonight. Routed out to second in the first inning and the fourth inning. He struck out in the fifth. One of two big strikeouts in that frame recorded by Wyatt Boone. You might recall the Elks had a run in, had the bases loaded with only one out, but Boone with back-to-back strikeouts of Parsons and Darren Johnson to get out of trouble. And then the momentum certainly swung in the Sweets' favor. Walla Walla scored 5 times in the top of the sixth inning. And the first pitch to Parsons is high, 1 ball, no strikes. Brady Heeroy. Lefty-lefty matchup here against Parsons. And Brady's 1-0 pitch on the way is grounded to the right side, taken by Chaz Martinez. His throw to Heeroy is behind him and not in time. So the leadoff hitter is aboard here in the bottom of the eighth inning. We'll wait and see how they score it. They will score it a base hit for Parsons. And that will bring up Darren Johnson. So Ben with the leadoff hitter aboard here in the last half of the eighth. And that is 10 hits in the game for the Bend Elks. Darren Johnson is 0 for 3. He has struck out twice. And he has flied to center field. Chaz Martinez will hold Parsons on at first base. The stretch by Heeroy. And the pitch on the way, it's there for a strike, 0-1. Eight-3 the Sweets here in the bottom of the eighth inning. A runner on with nobody out. Brady Heeroy to the stretch. Staring at first, pitch on the way, and it's swung on and missed, and the count is 0-2. No balls, 2 strikes on Darren Johnson, the Bend catcher. Gabe Gonzalez, who homered his last time up, is on deck. The stretch. And the 0-2 on its way, and it's high. Ball 1-1 and 2 strikes. 1-2 on Johnson. Brady Heeroy on this cold night. Looks in for the sign from Michael Petrie. He has it and goes to the stretch. It is 1-2 pitch on the way, and it misses low and outside. Ball 2, 2 balls and 2 strikes. 2-2 now on Darren Johnson. Brady Heeroy goes to the stretch. And the pitch on the way, and it's fouled back to the screen, and it's still 2-2 on Darren Johnson. He had a good cut there and fouled it back to the netting behind home plate. Still 2-2. Michael Petrie, the catcher, looking into the third base dugout. And he will soon relay signs to his battery mate, Brady Heeri. The stretch. And the 2-2 pitch on the way, swung on and missed for strike three. Runner occupying first, so Johnson is retired. That is the 11th strikeout in this game for Sweet's pitchers. The ball squirted away from Petrie, but he pounced on it. No reason to apply a tag to Johnson. Again, with first base occupied, no chance for the batter to try to advance to first base. And that'll bring up Gabe Gonzalez. He is 2-for-3 tonight. Parsons, his lead from first. The stretch by Heeri. And a throw to first to keep Parsons honest. Gonzalez, right-handed hitter. The stretch by Heeri. And the delivery on the way. And it's bounced to the left side. Farmer goes to second for one. Throw to first. Double play! 6-4-3! Farmer to Price to Martinez. And side retired. We go to the ninth inning. Walla Walla 8, Ben 3 on the Sweets Radio Network. Presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Hi, this is Doug with Columbia REA and Columbia iConnect. We are excited to partner again with the Walla Walla Sweets baseball team, so come on out and support the home team. Call us at 526-4041 for your internet needs with Columbia iConnect or your electrical needs for Columbia REA.
Holiday Inn Express Walla Walla is proud to be the official hotel of the Walla Walla Suite. Our guests are sure to get a great night's sleep in one of our recently remodeled rooms, and our 24-hour pool and spa are perfect for round-the-clock relaxation. Each night at Holiday Inn Express Walla Walla is followed by a complimentary breakfast included with every stay. At Holiday Inn Express Walla Walla, you can catch some Z's while the Suites catch some W's. Wins, that is.
It's now easier than ever to stay in touch on your smartphone, tablet, or computer with local community news, sports, and information from the Walla Walla Valley. Visit the Union Bulletin online and get the best in local sports and photography, plus trusted, need-to-know local community news and information. The UB is proud to support the Sweets and the Valley's communities and schools. Join the conversation at union-bulletin.com.
We go to the top of the ninth inning here in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia. The Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 8-3. Chaz Martinez will lead things off here in the top half of the ninth inning against left-hander Brendan Turcott, who has done an admirable job since coming in the seventh inning. And the pitch on the way to Martinez is high. One ball, no strikes. Chaz Martinez to be followed by Cesar Lopez and then Jordan Stubbings. And that delivery misses from Turcott. Ball two, two balls and no strikes. Chaz Martinez, one of the big blows in this game, a leadoff home run in the top of the sixth inning. And the pitch misses, ball three, three balls and no strikes. That home run, building on the momentum of the bottom of the fifth inning, when the Elks had a run in, had the bases loaded with only one out, but then Wyatt Boone showing some grit, striking out the next two hitters to end that frame as Chaz Martinez takes a strike, and it's 3-1. Three balls and a strike. And Turcott's pitch, it's low into the backstop, ball four. A leadoff walk to Chaz Martinez here in the ninth inning. And that'll bring up Cesar Lopez. Cesar so far tonight has a hit in four at-bats. He singled in the second. He popped out in the third, reached on an error in the sixth and scored. And grounded to second in the seventh inning. He was the first hitter to face Turcott. And the pitch on the way. Cesar takes a strike and the count is 0-1. No balls and one strike the count on Cesar. The stretch by Turcotte. He looks to first. And the pitch. And Cesar foul tips that pitch at the plate. And it's now 0-2. Cesar Lopez out of Cal Poly Pomona. Bats from the left-hand side. And throws from the right-hand side. Turcotte to the stretch. And his pitch on the way, the 0-2, is bounced. A high bounce to the right side, taken by the second baseman Cervantes, his throw to first in time. And on the play, Chaz Martinez advances to second base, one out. Our ninth inning this evening is presented by Chiquillas. And the next batter will be Jordan Stubbings. So Cesar advancing the runner with a high chopper to the right side. Jordan Stubbings walked his last time up in the seventh inning. The stretch by Turcotte. Looks back to second twice. And the pitch, it's low. A good stop by Darren Johnson, the catcher. One ball, no strikes. The Sweets start a three-game series tomorrow in Ridgefield. 1-0 pitch on the way, and Stubbings bounces it to the left side. Ball is taken by the third baseman. Needham is tossed across the diamond, is in time for out number two. And that will bring up Caleb Farmer. On the play, Chaz Martinez holding at second base. Caleb Farmer hit into a 4-6-3 double play his last time up, but prior to that, an RBI double in that 5-run sixth inning. The stretch by Turcotte. And the pitch, it's low. Ball one, one ball and no strikes. Again, the Sweets needing a victory here to maintain a one-game lead in the West Coast League South Division standings. The red-hot Corvallis Knights shutting out Ridgefield tonight by a score of 2-0. The Knights have now won 6 in a row. And the 1-0 pitch on its way. And it swung on and missed, and the count is 1-1 on Caleb Farmer. Chaz Martinez, his lead from second. The stretch by Turcotte. And the pitch. Farmer takes it over the inside corner for strike two, and the count is 1-2. At the moment, the Sweets with 9 hits in the ball game. Bend with 10. The stretch. The 1-2 pitch on its way to Caleb Farmer. And it's grounded to the left side foul. And the count remains. A ball and two strikes. Larry Price now occupying the third base coach's box. We have nobody coaching first. At least not that I can see anyway. A bat issue for Caleb Farmer. And a new one tossed out to him very emphatically. And skipper Frank Mutes tossing the ball across the diamond toward the Elks first base dugout. 1-2 on Caleb Farmer. Turcotte looks back to second. Looks in for the sign. He has it from Darren Johnson. Goes to the stretch. Looks back to second. And the 1-2 pitch on the way. Farmer fouls it back, and it's still 1-2. And two on Farmer. And Turcotte's 1-2 pitch on its way. And it's down low, ball two. Two balls and two strikes on Caleb Farmer. Ben Ferris would be next. The stretch by Turcotte. Looks back to second and the pitch. And Farmer fouls it down the right side. Back it out of play. And it's still two balls and two strikes. Two rainouts this evening in the West Coast League. Yakima Valley rained out at Port Angeles after dropping a doubleheader last night. They got to the bottom of the fifth inning in Kelowna, the Falcons hosting the Portland Pickles, and then they were halted because of rain. Next delivery to Farmer is outside, ball three, three balls and two strikes. And look at this, in the bottom of the ninth inning, Wenatchee and Victoria tied at 12. The stretch. And the payoff pitch on the way to Farmer, he lifts it in the air to right field. Coming up on the ball is Jarvis, and he makes the one-handed catch to retire the side. We go to the bottom of the ninth, Walla Walla 8, Bend 3 on the Sweets Radio Network, presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
With seven retail locations across eastern Washington, Blue Line is the region's go-to Kubota dealer. But Kubota is far from all we provide. Blue Line represents more than 10 lines of agriculture equipment, including Gregoire and Land Pride. We carry parts and provide service for all major tractor brands, and our knowledgeable staff and certified mechanics will ensure your satisfaction. Blue Line is a proud partner of the Walla Walla Sweets. Blue Line, building the future of agriculture.
Guess how much of this we're giving away this year? $2 million in cash and prizes. You're probably asking, where can I get some of that action? Legends Casino, that's where. Join the Rewards Club at legendscasino.com, because this is going to be a legendary year. Welcome to Legends Casino Hotel. Welcome to winning.
Hello fans, every day is a great day for the famous flavor of Nathan's Hot Dogs. So why not visit the concession stand right now and enjoy a great tasting Nathan's Famous Hot Dog. Nathan's Beef Hot Dogs are made today with the same secret spice as they were back in Coney Island 100 years ago. One bite into a delicious Nathan's Hot Dog and you'll understand why Nathan's Franks are world famous. They are juicy, beefy, and full of flavor. Enjoy Nathan's Hot Dog right now, the official hot dog sponsor of Major League Baseball.
We go to the bottom of the ninth inning here at Vince Guinness Stadium in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia, the Walla Walla Sweets leading the Bend Elks by a score of 8-3. Here in the bottom of the ninth, relief pitcher Brady Heri will face Jake Jarvis. Lead things off, and then back to the top of the order for Vinny Sabolta and Efri Cervantes. So here we go, the bottom of the ninth inning here at Vince Guinness Stadium, which is going to host this year's West Coast League All-Star Game. Jarvis stands in and awaits the first pitch from Brady Heri. And here it is. It's line foul down the left field line, 0-1. Jarvis is 1-for-3. He singled in the sixth inning and then was attempting to steal second. He was called out when it was ruled that Cervantes obstructed catcher Michael Petrie, and that ended the bottom of the sixth. Time called. Now Jarvis back in. And the 0-1 pitch on the way by Heri is popped up into left field. Over to his right to make the grab, Cesar Lopez for out number one. One down here in the bottom of the ninth. And that will bring up Vinny Zavolta. Zavolta has scored. He singled and scored in the first. He grounded it short in the third. He flew out to right in the fifth and again in the sixth. And the pitch on the way by Brady Heri is a strike, and it's 0-1. No balls and one strike on Zavolta. Brady Heroy has the sign from Michael Petrie, and his 0-1 pitch on the way, and it's a little high, ball one. One ball and one strike, the ball popping in and out of the glove of Michael that time. Heroy looks in for the sign once again. And after a bit of hesitation, delivers his 1-1 pitch. That's a little inside, ball two, two balls and one strike. Justin Foles at third, Caleb Farmer at shortstop, Parker Price at second, Chaz Martinez at first. 2-1 on Zavolta. And the pitch on the way by Heroy is bounced to the left side, just foul past the third base bag. And the count is two balls and two strikes. Brady Heroy entered in the bottom of the eighth inning, gave up a leadoff single to Parsons, an infield single. Then he struck out Darren Johnson and then got Gabe Gonzalez to hit into a 6-4-3 double play. We're in the bottom of the ninth inning here in Bend. 2-2. On Zavolta. And Heroy's pitch on the way. It's low. Ball three, three balls and two strikes. A full count on the Elks left fielder. Heroy has the sign. And his payoff pitch on its way. Breaking ball, hit up the middle, taken by the shortstop Farmer. And on the run, he throws wide of the mark and got Martinez off the bag. So Zavolta is safe at first, and we'll wait and see how they score it. A tough chance there. Farmer charging, and they're going to score it a base hit for Zavolta. An infield hit with one out here in the bottom of the ninth inning, and that will bring up Efrai Cervantes. Farmer coming in on the ball, a tough chance, his throw to first. Got Chaz Martinez off the bag, and Zavolta crosses first base safely. Cervantes so far tonight is 0-3. He has struck out three times. He walked and scored in the fifth, and the pitch is bounced to the left side foul, and the count is 0-1. No balls and one strike on Cervantes. We have reached the three-hour mark in this ball game. Again, started at around 7:17 this evening. A 42-minute delay because of inclement weather. 8-3 the Sweets here in the bottom of the ninth. One on with one out. Brady Heroy to the stretch. Looks to first. And his pitch is swung on and missed. And it's 0-2. Nothing and two on Cervantes of the Bend Elks. Heroy with the sign. He goes to the stretch. And here is his 0-2 pitch. And it's swung and missed for strike three. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night, Brady Heroy says to Efrai Cervantes. Two down. And that'll bring up Chase Fernland. An RBI double in the fifth. He grounded a second in the first. He walked in the third and struck out, leading off the bottom of the seventh. Two down. And one on. Fernland, the batter. Brady Heroy to the stretch. Looks to first. And the pitch on the way, and it's high off the glove of Michael Petrie. He hustles to his right to retrieve the ball. One ball, no strikes. Zavolta at first base. A cautious lead over there. Before the previous pitch, being held on over there by Chaz Martinez. 1-0 is the count on Fernland. And he rides pitch. It's low and inside. Ball two. Two balls and no strikes. 2-0 on Fernland. That pitch in the dirt and smothered by Sweets catcher Michael Petrie. 2-0 on Fernland. Zavolta, his lead from first. The stretch. And the pitch on the way, the 2-0 is there for a strike, and it's 2-1. Two balls and one strike on Chase Fernland. The Sweets leading 8-3 here in the bottom of the ninth. The stretch and the pitch on the way. Hirai finds a good chunk of home plate with that one. And it's a called second strike on Chase Fernland. Two balls and two strikes. Patrick Caulfield, the center fielder, shaded a bit into right center for Fernland. The stretch. And the 2-2 pitch on the way, it's hit up the middle into center field, a base hit. So Fernland keeps the contest alive with a base hit up the middle. And that is the 12th hit in the ball game for the Bend Elks, and that will bring up Dayton Provost, the designated hitter. Now two on with two out for Dayton Provost, who is 2-for-3. He singled for an RBI in the first. He singled in the third. He walked in the fifth. He struck out in the seventh. Brady Hirai trying to finish this thing off. The runners their leads. Chaz Martinez back at first base, not holding on the runner there, of course, with a runner at second. And the pitch. It's outside, ball one. One ball and no strikes. Two on, two out here in the bottom of the ninth. The Sweets leading 8-3. The stretch by Hirai. Look back to second. And the pitch. It's swung on and missed. And it's 1-1. A ball and a strike on Provost. The stretch. And Hirai's pitch. And it's outside. Ball two. Two balls and one strike. 2-1 on Provost. Runners there leads. The stretch by Hirai. He looks back to second. And the pitch. And it's grounded to the left side. Going to be a tough play for Farmer. Farmer throws across his body. In time, I believe. Yes, and the ball game is over. What a play by Caleb Farmer, ranging to his right and throwing on the run, a strike to Chaz Martinez at first, and this ball game is over, and the Walla Walla Sweets salvage the final game of this three-game series with the Bend Elks. The Sweets victorious by a final score of 8-3. The Sweets stay atop the West Coast League South Division standings. And now they look ahead to a three-game series beginning tomorrow night in Ridgefield. Walla Walla 8, Bend 3. And we'll be back to wrap it up after we take a timeout on the Sweets Radio Network presented by Nathan's Famous Hot Dogs.
Life is more fun without ATM fees. So switch to Banner Bank Connected Checking. Use any ATM in the country and we'll refund the fees. Spend what you earn on what you love with Connected Checking from Banner Bank. Switch today at bannerbank.com or at a Banner Bank branch near you. Unlimited surcharge rebates from non-banner owned ATMs in the U.S. Banner Bank, member FDIC.
The smell of fresh cut barley. The sound of boots in a barn. The sight of the sun rising over the fields. Budweiser farmers don't just grow barley, they live it. That's because there's nothing simple about growing barley. It's early mornings every morning. It's a steady hand guiding a combine through the field. It's a loyalty to the land, and it's a respect for those who did it before you did. Barley is the soul of our lager. That's why we've been working with the same family-owned American farms for more than 50 years to harvest it. The secrets to growing this grain perfectly have been passed down through three generations. For them, it's a legacy. It's something to be proud of. And it's why only the best barley and locally sourced ingredients are used to make Budweiser. Budweiser is proudly raised across America. This Bud's from our barley farmers. This Bud's for you. Enjoy responsibly. Budweiser Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Back once again at Vince Gennett Stadium in Bend, Oregon. I'm Roy Elia. The Walla Walla Sweets salvage the final game of this three-game series with the Bend Elks. They prevail tonight by a final score of 8-3. Final numbers on the ball game. First for the Sweets, 8 runs, 9 hits, and no errors. They stranded 7 for the Bend Elks, 3 runs, 12 hits, 1 error, and the Elks stranded 10 in tonight's ball game. Bend got off to a 1-0 lead in the bottom of the first inning, an RBI single by Provost. Then the Sweets took a 2-1 lead in the third inning, a 2-run home run by Patrick Caulfield. Bend equalized in the bottom of the fifth inning. Scored once, but perhaps that was the turning point of this ball game. Bend had a run in, the bases loaded, with only one out. Reliever Wyatt Boone, who grudgingly gave up that run in the bottom of the fifth, then posted back-to-back strikeouts of Justin Parsons and Darren Johnson to get out of trouble. And then in the top of the sixth, Chaz Martinez leads off a very productive inning with a solo home run to right center field. And that was the beginning of a 5-run sixth inning for the Sweets, which also included an RBI double by Caleb Farmer, an RBI single by Michael Petrie, and an RBI single by Parker Price, and a sacrifice fly by Patrick Caulfield. The Sweets led 7-2, and then in the bottom of the sixth inning, a solo home run to left field by Gabe Gonzalez made it 7-3. The Sweets add another run in the top of the eighth inning on a Patrick Caulfield double to right field that caps a 4-RBI night for the soon-to-be UCLA Bruin. And then some effective pitching by the Sweets bullpen. And let's also tip our hat to starter Andrew Mosiello, who threw 3 very respectable innings here this evening. The Sweets also getting respectable outings on the mound as well from Wyatt Boone, Dimmick Wood, and Brady Heri. And the Sweets victorious tonight by a final score of 8-3. The Sweets improved to 13-5 on the season. They snap a 3-game losing streak. They salvage the final game of this 3-game series. More importantly, they stay atop the West Coast League's South Division standings, 1 game up on 3-time defending league champion Corvallis. Another final to pass along to you. A non-league game, the Cowlitz Black Bears defeated tonight at home by the Highline Bears, a final score of 7-2, and they're going to extra innings. That wild, wild game up north. Wenatchee Apple Sox in a 12-12 tie with the Victoria Harbor Cats. A couple other games rained out this evening. And of course, Corvallis winning tonight over Ridgefield 2-0. Tomorrow night, we will be in Ridgefield to bring you the first game of a 3-game series between the Walla Walla Sweets and Ridgefield Raptors. The scheduled start time is 6:35. We will take the air tomorrow night at around 6:25 to bring you more Walla Walla Sweets baseball. For my outstanding tech guru, Aaron Page, I'm Roy Elia telling you one final time, the Walla Walla Sweets victorious tonight. West Coast League baseball action. They knock off the Bend Elks by a final score of 8-3. Until tomorrow night, I'm Roy Elia reporting from Bend, Oregon, wishing each and every one of you in Sweets Nation a very pleasant good evening.